Listening to the Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios.
You are causing a major disturbance on my time.
If I'm here and you're here, doesn't that make it our time?
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station. Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
There's a lot of Lions, Tigers, and Bears, but they even one Razorback. Number one.
This is the Morning Rush.
Borderline erotic.
With Ty Richardson.
Sunshine.
That's cool. I can dig it.
And Tommy Kraft.
Do I look happy?
What's wrong?
Lloyd!
The Morning Rush starts right now.
How about the Arkansas softball team doing what they did last night? They get a share of the regular season SEC title for the first time in school history. Really awesome to see Courtney Dyfel take that program far beyond where it was when she took it over years back. And that's a team that a lot of people have gotten excited about on campus. But what is the team that's the most sellable right now on campus? Is it the baseball team that's the unanimous number one team in the country? Is it the basketball team that had the best team in the past 25 plus years? Is it the football team just because it's football? Something we'll discuss later on the program. When you think about turnover within staff on the Arkansas basketball team or the transfers, that's something that you're going to continue to see, something Eric Musselman has done throughout his career. What's more difficult to navigate with? What's more difficult to get through? Is it turnover within the staff or is it turnover within the players? Then also, I saw that Thursday Night Football was moving to Amazon Prime this year. You think about how annoying it is sometimes dealing with the SEC Network alternate channel, SEC Network Plus. What's that going to be like? Are you going to get annoyed by this as well? I think a lot of you will, because I know I will. And then it's also National Concert Day here on a Tuesday, a Toyota Tuesday.
How you doing?
I'm all right.
You boys safe? Did y'all get woke up with the tornado siren, the Nader sirens last night?
I went to bed by 9 o'clock, 45 minutes later. Remember, you know where the tornado siren is.
Is it by your house?
It's directly on top of our house.
Oh, really?
So I shot out of bed.
Yeah.
Like a cannon, and just, I was so happy. I was like, I'm going to get to bed early. I'm tired. I've done my work previously for this morning. Sure enough, 45 minutes later,
yeah,
boom.
Yeah, we had, I know across wherever you're listening this morning, I'm not sure about South Arkansas for those listening down in South Arkansas this morning on 97.1, but I'm telling you, Western Arkansas, particularly south of the tunnel in the River Valley, it was kind of hairy there for a little bit last night. Not so much. I mean, there was a few spin ups or whatever, and we were trying to watch the news to keep up with it. But power going in and out. But I woke up this morning. I couldn't really see much last night. Guys, I go out in the driveway this morning. I got like half a tree laying across part of my driveway. So, what are y'all doing after the show? Anybody got a chainsaw handy? Work gloves.
Smackdown Heat. I think you can handle that solo. You
probably some good smoking wood or something.
I mean, yeah, I can have like
the top half of a, I think it's a hickory tree. I can't, you know, boom, crash down right on the driveway.
So. I'll butter up the boss if there's a trip. If there's any trips that are coming up, absolutely. I'll be there, boss.
Get you to Omaha.
So that was one of the
leaves everywhere.
You ever ran a chainsaw, Ty?
Have I ran a chainsaw? Yes. No. That would have been back when. I haven't done it since I was in high school, but yes, I have done that before. So, one of the things that my roommate, since you talked about a tree fall, and one of the things my roommate mentioned is like, the tornado's not near us. And then as I was walking in bed, he's like, but I'm just worried about a tree falling on our house. And so imagine like just sitting in bed hoping that you don't just have this giant oak just go through your room.
I know it. That's exactly right. So, I mean, particularly with all the rain we had last week, a little more dangerous. My next door neighbor, great guy, Jordan, he's in the roofing business. When we were talking last night, he said, dude, if we get hit with a big hailstorm, I don't know if there's enough roofing supplies to go around. Shortage, you know, there's a shortage on everything. Mm-hmm. COVID has gotten blamed for everything. Now, if I don't think we got a bunch of hail last night, but probably a lot of people, when the daylight comes up this morning, going to figure out where it's at. Now, I think as it moved east, from what I could see, because I stayed up a little bit late with this to just kind of check all regions of our coverage area and our facilities and towers and all that stuff kind of dissipated a bit, but there for a while last night, about 9 o'clock, 9:30, it was It was some bad stuff as it came in from Oklahoma and Arkansas.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, driving in this morning.
Arkansas got a dose of it, but maybe not quite as bad last night. They've had their share of it here lately. So I know most of us listening this morning got a piece of the weather in some way, shape, or form last night.
Was there actually a tornado? Because wasn't it?
I don't know. I guess they probably won't know until they go out and survey. But I know this, when I got summoned downstairs, and I'm one of these that, listen, unless it's really bad, I'm not getting up. I'm not going all the way down. We got a room downstairs that no windows. It's in the basement. It's the safest spot in the house. And I guess I need to go down there and set the example because the kids go in there. My wife is.
Is there an Xbox?
Really?
In there?
No, but they are scared of the storm. I mean, she is. This gets her undivided attention. And they get the cats. Everybody goes. So they, you know, I've got to go in there to appease everybody. But I got woke up last night. Dad, we got to get down there. So,
yeah, well, you went to a tornado shelter last night. I asked my roommates who were monitoring the situation because I just woke up and my hair was in a tizzy and just kind of like, I didn't know where, I mean, just, you know, when you wake up and you're just like,
yeah, you're disoriented. Yeah.
And I was like, hey, do we need to go to tornado shelter? And it's like, we'll tell you if we do. And then the alarm.
And then what are you going to do? The wind's blowing, the rain's coming down. You want to get out in that to go to the shelter?
The alarm went off moments later, and I could go back to bed. But then it was thundering and lightning pretty good last night, so it was hard to fall back to sleep. Yeah. Alan and Alma text in. He says, come over to my house north of Alma. Plan on all-day work.
Yeah.
Tree down in his yard and a fence destroyed.
I'm going to tell you.
Sorry about that, buddy.
You got chainsaws, trailers, cleaning up tools today. You can stay busy with that. So just hope everyone's safe out there. I know there was a lot of pictures on 5 News. I was watching them last night, and trees down on houses and buildings and stuff all over the place. So hope everybody's good this morning.
Yeah.
So anyway, well, it's cool to see before all this hit, the softball team clinch, as you mentioned, that piece of the conference title. Maybe they can get the outright part of that. But
Gators have to win 3 games this weekend for them to tie with Arkansas. So there's a good chance that Arkansas could walk.
Is Arkansas
away with
done? Pardon me.
I think so.
Okay,
so based on how I read it,
so
based on the email.
What a reclamation project here that Courtney Diefel's pulled out over the last 6 years. This is her 6th season at Arkansas, and I'll be honest. I don't follow softball. It's been fun to read about this year and get the emails from the sports information department, and you know, kind of keep up with that and see the kind of the campus wide success, and that's been part of it this year. But I've got a friend of mine that. He watches every one of these things.
Really?
He knows where it's at on the streaming. He knows what time they play. He can tell you about Burnside. He can go down the roster. If we needed somebody to come on this show and spend 10 minutes talking about the softball team, he'd be our guy.
Can either of you name a player?
Burnside be it. Yeah. Exactly.
What's her first name?
Gracie, isn't it?
There you
Braxton
go.
Burnside. Huh? Braxton Burnside.
Braxton, see, I was wrong about that.
Hannah Gamble.
Okay.
Yeah.
Connection.
You did some PA for him, didn't you?
Keeley Huffine. Yeah, I did some PA for him.
My connection is Autumn Storms because that's one of my great buddies from high school. They're dating. So that's the connection I have to the – and I say it's a very loose connection. I met her once.
You'll claim it though, right?
Yeah, I met her once, but she's really nice, and she's had a heck of a season too.
We'll always celebrate championships or pieces here in Arkansas. So
but it's like
good
you said,
them.
With Courtney Diefel, just – from where she took the program originally to where it is now, it's awesome. I mean, Dave Van Horn was talking about how much they've turned it around. He's excited because it just brings more attention. I know baseball and softball are two different sports, but he's happy for her. And I think a lot of Arkansas fans are, as Tommy mentioned, because you love celebrating championships, you love celebrating Razorback success, and that's exactly what this basketball team is, or excuse me, this softball team is right now, which is just – frankly, awesome. And I think there's a lot of people that should be excited about this softball program and where Courtney Diefel is headed moving forward. 877-377-6963 is our number that you can hop in here this morning. We've already got Ryan and Hot Springs on the line. We're going to talk about just what program is the most sellable team right now for Arkansas sports. Got some quickening headlines to get to. It is National Concert Day. What your favorite concert you've ever been to is. All that's coming up, Toyota Tuesday edition of The Morning Rush.
This is Toyota Tuesday on The Morning Rush. Get by your local Toyota dealer for a test drive today. Toyota, let's go places.
Wheels RV in Springdale wants you to seek out all the natural state has to offer this year. Explore Arkansas in a new RV from Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, or Alliance. All the best brands at the best prices. Enjoy peace of mind with our lifetime warranty on every new RV and a mobile service shuttle to keep you camping. So come on in and discover why Wheels RV was voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. 5 miles west of I-49, exit 72. Seek, explore, discover with Wheels RV.
Hi, I'm Bill Bolton of NWA Gold, Silver, and Coins. I started this business in 1972 at an auction house that specialized in antique and estate jewelry, sterling silver, and coins. In that time, I've seen gold go from $35 an ounce to today's price of $1,683. I want to talk to you about the coins you may have inherited and how important it is to deal with someone who understands coins and this market. In 2011, we had a mother and daughter come into our store and sell us a lot of jewelry they no longer wore for $3,300. The daughter then pulled out an 1850 California $10 gold piece. Jeremy offered her $900, and she accepted his offer. He then advised her to have this coin graded. She did, and she sold it for $36,000. If you don't know what you have, please come see Jeremy in our Bentonville store. Don't sell it at an auction or an estate sale and get less money. What's in your safety deposit box could be worth thousands. NWA Gold, Silver, and Coins, Bentonville, Fayetteville.
Do you remember the joy you felt as a kid about pizza night? Remember how good it smelled? You could taste it even before you opened the box. And then, that first bite. It was so good. Be the supper time savior. Order Jim's Razorback Pizza now. 434-3456. The best pizza in Fort Smith or it's free. Jim's Razorback
Pizza. Was your roof damaged by recent storms? Don't fall victim to out-of-town contractors and fly-by-night repairmen. Trust the local roofing professionals at Able Roofing. Call their local number, 474-0006, for a free roof inspection. Never trust something as important as the roofing system on your home to a storm chaser. Able Roofing, 474-0006, will work with your insurance company. Call now for your free roof inspection, 474-0006. Able Roofing, the hometown roofers.
Come try out the new Koper Radix Woods and Irons or the TaylorMade Sim2 Woods and Irons at the Golf Nut, 5121 Towson Avenue in Fort Smith. Spend some time on the putting green and try out a great selection of Scotty Cameron putters. In stock now, TaylorMade TP5s or the Callaway Super Soft Golf Balls. Need a push cart? Choose from Sun Mountain, Rovic, or Click Gear. As always, don't forget to check Facebook for daily specials. The best place for all your golfing needs, the Golf Nut, Fort Smith's number one golf shop since 1994.
Locally owned Lumber One can handle all of your building needs. They've built their business on having great relationships with everybody from contractors and builders to the everyday build-it-yourself. Lumber One is a full-line door shop to handle all of your door, window, and trim needs. And along with lumber, roofing and drywall products, attic wall and floor insulation is available. Lumber One also does blueprint takeoff with access to design services with estimates available. So go where the pros go. Lumber One, located on Industrial Park Road in Van Buren.
Hey, grounds guys.
Hey, what?
How'd you like to mow my lawn?
You betcha. If you want your lawn professionally maintained, the grounds guys is your one-stop shop. The grounds guys will mow, trim, edge, blow away all the debris off your sidewalks and driveway, and keep your lawn the envy of the neighborhood all year long. Call 479-303-GUYS. That's 303-GUYS. Or go to groundsguys.com for all your lawn care needs in Northwest Arkansas and the Fort Smith area. The grounds guys. Leave the yard work to us.
Farm Credit has been a trusted friend for over 100 years. They are ag financing experts. So whether you're a longtime farmer, new to farming, or buying your dream home or land in the country, their experienced staff has a plan to fit your goals, needs, and your bottom line. From farms to land, livestock, equipment, and more, Farm Credit finances it all. Learn more at myaglender.com. Farm Credit is an equal opportunity lender.
Standard Materials Group has immediate openings for ready-mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. If you have a CDL license without an automatic restriction and want to be home every night, want to work with a company that offers great pay, benefits, and a great team environment with growth opportunities, apply today at jobs.crh.com. Again, that's jobs.crh.com. Standard Materials Group is an equal opportunity employer.
Congratulations, you're having a little girl.
At that moment, everything changed. Our hopes and dreams for ourselves were instantly replaced by our hopes and dreams for her. We got life insurance policies from Shelter Insurance, so that regardless of what life throws at us, we'll still be able to provide the world to her.
Shelter Life Insurance Company, Columbia, Missouri.
Ask Shelter agents Ted McAvoy or Jeff Clark about a free insurance review.
ESPN 95.3.
The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
And Moore drives one to right field. There it goes back. Number 11 for Robert Moore. It's 10-2.
Mother's Day is coming up. Fill out the best TV mom's bracket at hitthatline.com for your chance to win prizes from Gregory Jewelers, Premier Day Spa, and Overstreet's Jewelers.
Got a funny text in here via Twitter, Tommy. It says, this is from Handsome Johnny. I literally have a tornado shelter being installed in the garage today. Got hit in 2013 and been wanting one ever since. I've never been so excited about a metal box that doesn't connect to the internet or doesn't have an engine in my entire life. 45-year-old priorities are so boring.
They even make those where they'll cut a hole in your garage floor and then dig it out underneath your garage. I've seen those too.
We do not have a tornado shelter at our house, but we're close enough to, we're less than a mile away from one, so.
Lowe's or Home Depot. Yeah, but the problem is when the sirens go off, you know, all hell is breaking loose and there's storms and hail and, and I mean, who knows what's going on. You really want to drive your car over to a middle school or whatever's in your neighborhood, and is that more dangerous?
So what needs to, because you know our.
You got to go early.
Our dryer's still broken. What's the priority? Do we need to tell my tenant and my roommate, hey, you need to get us a tornado shelter, or you need to fix the dryer?
I think you probably need to price them tornado shelters, and you'd probably buy a bunch of dryers first.
Are they pretty expensive?
Yeah, expensive.
Ugh.
But what's your life worth?
A lot.
There you go.
A lot. Let's go to Ryan in Hot Springs. Ryan, do you have a tornado shelter at your house, buddy?
Actually, I do. Whenever I inherited my grandfather's place, it had one.
Okay.
You got it, but not.
Is it one of the old school ones that are dug out in the ground in the backyard? Had the heavy metal door, and you never knew what kind of spider or snake was going to be in the bottom of this thing.
Pretty much. Yeah. You got to keep cotton balls in there.
Yeah.
It's not good.
I've been in a few of them when I was a kid. So.
What does cotton balls do?
I guess I would have to say probably the football is probably the most sellable, and I think that's just because that's just what our fan base has the passion for, and I hate that for baseball. I'm not saying we don't love our baseball team, but it just seems that the football is our moneymaker, and the fact that we had the best season we've had in three or four almost 5 years, that's kind of sad to say. But the improvement, I think, I have to say it has to be football.
Mm-hmm. Well, the reason. Go ahead.
I also wanted to make a comment too about the Amazon Prime. I wonder if they're gonna like do that for three or four games and then ditch it and then go back to like Fox and then switch back to NFL Network. Mm-mm. It never seems that like they can get settled on a channel.
Yeah, Thursday Night Football is kind of odd how they go about that. Appreciate your call, Ryan. Now, SmackDown, you have a buddy that works in the ticket department, and I was actually talking to one of my friends this weekend who had an opportunity to take a job that Patrick does. And the reason I've asked this question is because he told me it was extremely difficult to try and sell football tickets towards the end of the Brett Bielema era and Chad Morris. And you think about there's more money, more revenue, more tickets in football. But I just want to know from a ticket office perspective, when you pick up the phone and you call X Booster or X Fan and you say, hey, we got upgraded seats, we got this, we got that, what's easier to upsell them in? Is it football, is it basketball, or is it baseball? You say baseball, I think that's...
Well, from that perspective, it might be different. The availability in baseball, go try to buy baseball season tickets anywhere, between the bases, anywhere between the dugouts right now. You can't get them. Mm-hmm. It's sold out, and you're not going to get them. You know, just buying chair back reserve seats is difficult to do. Mm-hmm. So, from the way you're setting that up, baseball, that's an impossible job because there's no availability.
Yeah. And the reason I kind of asked this question is because they got the one Razorback road show that's kicking off in a couple weeks. They're going to go to Harrison, Dumas, Hot Springs, Little Rock, Russellville, Jasper, Sheridan, Pine Bluff, Mount Ida, Conway, Morrilton are some of the places they're going to go. And you know the reason for the events. They're trying to pick up ticket sales. They're trying to pick up revenue for the Razorback Foundation and trying to get people excited.
Generate excitement.
Yeah, for the football team and the other programs. And think about the softball program, as we just talked about. The basketball program's generating excitement. Mm-hmm. Baseball team's number one unanimous team in the country. There is a lot of excitement surrounding Arkansas athletics. And I'm just, like I said, coming back to the question I ask, is it still is football when your buddy Patrick is selling these different tickets, is he having the most difficult, because there's difficulties per thing, like you mentioned, not a lot of baseball tickets. Nope. So it's hard to find tickets to sell.
It's probably a hard question to answer from his perspective, just because of the year that they've had to go through.
Well,
because every time I've ever called him asking for tickets, whether it was baseball or prior to this, like it was always hard because there was never nothing there. Well,
and it depends on what, to me, I would rather sit at home than take a bad seat in the stadium. I'd rather stay at home and watch it on TV than sit upper deck in the football stadium. But that's me. Not everyone. Some people just want to be in the environment, be in the atmosphere, go tailgating.
And say they were there.
If I'm going to make the effort to go to the game, I want a good seat to see the game. Whether it's basketball, baseball, or football. And
what's a good seat to you?
Well, I mean, sidelines in football and basketball. I want to, you know, somewhere between the bases or the dugouts or something like that.
Okay.
In baseball. So, if not, the TV experience for me is better, and I think I get a better feel and understanding of what happened in the contest. But, and that's one of the difficulties with basketball right now. You talk about this sellability. Go try to put four seats for your family together in the lower bowl on a sideline. It's almost impossible to do unless you're Daddy Warbucks and you got 10 grand to drop for a donation. You know, it's just not there because people have had them for years and they're generational tickets and companies have them, you know. And to me, that's the next level. How do you have so much excitement with these programs? And that's the challenge for basketball moving forward. And I think they've met a lot of that challenge. How do you get people so excited they're willing to sit in the upper deck corner and pay for that for the whole year versus watch on TV? That's a big ask for me, but there's going to be a lot of people that, hey, I'll do it because I want to go to at least half the games. May not go to all of them, but I want the access and the guarantee to be there when I want to.
Well, we know programs, particularly in college, are made from the fan that's willing to sit in the rain in the top level upper corner and watch his or her beloved Hogs. And that's not to diminish the booster that's paying tens of thousands of dollars to go, but it's a combination of both. You can't have one without the other in order for programs to be successful, not just from a financial standpoint, but from a fan standpoint as well.
The cash register has to ring to make it all work. Hey, don't let mosquitoes, ticks, fleas ruin your outdoor activities this spring and summer. Our friends at Mosquito Joe can help you with that, an Arkansas family-owned business that makes outdoors fun again. For mosquito, tick, and flea-free yard this spring and summer, it's one call away to Mosquito Joe of Arkansas, 479-202-9960. That's 202-9960. Your first service is only $39. Find out more at arkansas.mosquitojoe.com.
Hey, Christian Freitlin won SEC Player of the Week, not Co-Player of the Week.
This is Toyota Tuesday on the Morning Rush. Get by your local Toyota dealer for a test drive today. Toyota, let's go places.
Cash and carry savings during the month of May at Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. Above ground pools start at just $19.99. Check out the semi-in-ground pools starting at $99.97. Plus special savings on chemical packages to get your pool off to the right start this summer. Cash and carry savings all month long at Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. And always online at burtonpools.com. Burton Pools and Spas, your source for backyard fun.
It's time to say goodbye to contacts, glasses, or bifocals with LASIK or clear lens exchange by Bold Vision in Northwest Arkansas. Mention ESPN for $500 off your LASIK or clear lens exchange procedure. A quick 15-minute procedure, easy 24-hour recovery no matter your age. Freedom from contacts and glasses is an option for you. Bold Vision, the official eye care providers of the Arkansas Razorbacks. Go Hogs! Discount cannot be combined with other offers or discounts.
Standard Materials Group has immediate openings for ready-mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. If you have a CDL license without an automatic restriction and want to be home every night, want to work with a company that offers great pay, benefits, and a great team environment with growth opportunities, apply today at jobs.crh.com. Again, that's jobs.crh.com. Standard Materials Group is an equal opportunity employer.
There's an old saying, the more things change, the more they stay the same. Hi, this is Scott at Calico County. 2021 is here, and no doubt a lot has changed in the last year. But something that has stayed the same is Calico County's award-winning food. Great portions that are fresh and always cooked from scratch. Something that we have changed is improved curbside service for those of you that don't want to fight the crowds. And of course, we will never change those great cinnamon rolls that everyone loves. So for breakfast, lunch, dinner, or catering, it's Calico County, just off Rogers Avenue, behind Randall Ford.
Hi folks, Larry Rath here for Rath Auto Resources, where it's trading time. I really need to keep my lot stocked, so all this month, I'm giving up to $3,100 extra for your trade. Even if you still owe money on your car, up to $3,100 extra goes a long way to help you get into a nicer, newer car today. Call, go online, or come by and choose from a great selection of Rath Road Ready cars, trucks, and SUVs. Each one hand-picked and inspected in our Meineke Car Care Center. Plus, our For the People credit approval process works with the country's best banks and lenders to make sure you drive off with a payment you can afford. If you're keeping the car you have, let us take care of it for you in our Meineke Car Care Center with free AC performance checks, half-off brakes, and buy three, get one free on all tires. Better yet, trade it in for something nicer and newer today and get up to $3,100 extra on trade during trading time at Arkansas's favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources, and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online, rathauto.com.
Requires bank approval. Negative equity may be refinanced. Offer absolutely ends by May 31st, 2021.
Franco Furniture is your Made in the USA headquarters. We carry as many Made in the USA products as we can, including Jackson and Catnapper sofas and Love, Speed Queen washers and dryers, and Serenity mattresses. This month, we are offering special pricing on cash and finance. We are family-owned, offer in-store no-credit check financing, and service after the sale. Deals on cash and credit. In-store no-credit check financing is available. Franco Furniture, 405 Fort Street, Barling, Arkansas. Best seats in the house.
Fitness will always be about keeping a routine. And the best routines in life will always make time for enjoying yourself. Michelob Ultra, superior light beer. Enjoy responsibly. AB Michelob Ultra Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
New Bud Light Seltzer?
Yep.
A hard seltzer with a hint of fruit flavor?
Yep.
Can I try one?
Yep.
That tastes great.
Told ya.
Bud Light Seltzer, unquestionably good. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Seltzer. IRC Beers, beer in Texas, St. Louis, Missouri.
Are your real estate investments being properly managed? Are you sending a check or cashing a check each month? If you're tired of your current property managers, then call Trinity Multifamily. Trinity will qualify your tenants and leases, inspect your properties, and take care of maintenance and provide you with web-based access to current financial reports, leases, and pictures of your property. Call Trinity Multifamily at 479-452-1817 or online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
Game Time Energy, lifetime experience. Learn more about Buffalo Wild Wings and why it's a great place to work. Apply today at work4wings.com. You'll be working with the hottest brand around and having tons of fun doing it. Welcome to the big time.
Join the winning team at Buffalo Wild Wings. We are hiring. Apply now at work4wings.com. Competitive pay, team member discounts, flexible schedule, insurance options, incentive contests, and much more. Work where every day is game day. Roar!
ESPN 95.3.
Good morning to the Morning Rush, everybody.
Swung on and belted high and deep to right by Moore. Eister's back to the wall. That's out of here. Robert Moore.
Your home for Razorback baseball all season long right here. HitThatLine.com.
Nick texts us in this morning, Tommy. He's a police officer in Fort Smith, and he just got off work. Wild night. He was a full-time police officer and a part-time street department worker last night with all the trees and,
yeah,
and power lines down.
I like I said, I couldn't see a lot around my house last night. You know, it wasn't a full moon, so unless you had a flashlight or a lot, and it was still raining hard. So as I was getting out this morning, you know, 5:15, I got half a tree down in my front yard. The top half got blown out. We had 80, 90 mile an hour winds at my house. And I mean, the front yard looks like a tree bomb went off. I mean, just little branches and leaves and stuff everywhere. And, you know, I'm going to have to go back once we get done this morning, figure out what's going on. But, yeah, roof damage. There's going to be a lot of people doing cleanup next day or two. And so I was coming up my road. They're, you know, dodging tree limbs and little, you know, nothing that blocked the road, no full trees down, but, mm-hmm, you know, stuff that's going to have to be moved out of the way. So
you brought up the, like, just being worried about a tree. Is that a fear of a homeowner? Because I'm not a homeowner, I'm a home renter, but I had never thought about a tree falling through my roof until my roommate said, I don't think the tornado's here. And I don't know if they did this on purpose, just be worried about a tree falling through our house. And I'm thinking to myself, like, as I'm just laying there in bed, if this could totally happen. But has that ever happened, as a homeowner?
Well, yeah, but I mean, let me ask you, does it matter if you rent or own if the tree's laying on your chest? I don't think it really matters if you're writing a check to the bank or to the landlord every month if it's, you know, laying across your forehead. I don't think that is not, boy, I wish I owned this home. As the tree comes, I don't think that'll be your last thought. So,
do you have anyone that can motivate you enough to, if a tree lands on you, to push it off you? Because, you know, there's always these mother or father stories where their kid has a car on them or something like that, and they have all this adrenaline. They lift a car. They lift something they have no business being able to do in just a regular instant moment. Is there someone that can motivate you to lift a tree off your chest?
Well, if it was one of my kids, I think you could muster the adrenaline, muster the courage
to save
one of your kids. Yeah. But that'd probably be the one thing. But
I think about that scene in Batman Begins where Ra's al Ghul's burning down Bruce Wayne's house and Alfred muddles over and Christian Bale, Bruce Wayne, has the roof on him, and he's like, "What's the point of you doing all those bloody push-ups if you can't lift a log?" And he just throws it off of him like that.
I know the River Valley got hit a little harder going east. I know Danny's on the line from Russellville. I think it kind of dissipated a little bit. I need to get a good report from Northwest Arkansas. I was watching the news. All the news coverage last night was kind of south of the tunnel, Sebastian, Crawford County. But I know Northwest Arkansas got a dose of it. I don't think the winds were as bad in Washington and Benton County. But we've had a couple of rounds of it here already, either flash floods and heavy rains or what we saw last night, which was not as much a rain event. It was a wind event last night.
A lot of it. Danny, how are you doing this morning?
Good morning, guys.
What happened there last night?
I look out my window and I have no trees down, so that's good.
That's good.
Matt asked me if I slept all night. I didn't even know it stormed. But congratulations to the softball team. You know, what, three or four years ago, they were one game, and now they're going 19-5 in the SEC, one of the best leagues in softball. So they got a good team. They depend heavily on home runs, and you know, you sometimes get up against good pitching, you got to manufacture a run here, run there. In the same way with the baseball team, you know, they lead the nation in home runs, and when we hit home runs, we win. But when you get up against great pitching sometimes, and one thing, they've been able to manufacture some runs, so you feel good about their chances of going to Omaha. Guys, the football team, one drafted player is all we had,
Is that true?
Yeah, yes. Correct. Jonathan Marshall to the New York Jets.
That's just not going to get it, guys. And I'm sure in the future we're going to have much more. But really, this year is going to be so important for Arkansas football. We've got to step up, move forward. We can't just be running in quicksand. We've got to show real improvement, especially on our defense. And I don't know.
Danny, let me ask you a question, because this was my take yesterday. Are you more impressed with the 3-win season after seeing just one draft selection off this team? Are you more impressed with what this coaching staff pulled off, saying, hey, this was clearly not a team overloaded with NFL talent?
Yeah, it kind of explains some of the records we've had the last couple of years. One drafted NFL player.
If you'd had eight players go in the draft and you'd won three games, you'd be scratching your head the other way, right?
Yeah, and we've had that happen before.
Mm-hmm.
A few years back on Bielema's teams, he'd have, several players drafted in the NFL, and we'd win, three or four games. That's not right. But anyway, guys, it's a big, important year for the football team, and I trust Sam Pittman in the recruiting. And go Hogs. You guys have a good day.
Danny, thanks, appreciate Danny. The call. It all starts with the recruiting. As we know right now, Arkansas is a top 15 class for 2022. It helps that the in-state recruiting class has definitely been upped, and hopefully they'll continue to get commits within the state and out of the state that have a desire to turn this football program around this next season. I'll tell you, a program that doesn't need to be turned around because it's been turned around for decades, and that's the Arkansas baseball team. Christian Franklin wins the SEC Player of the Week. I know a lot of people really excited about that because it wasn't a co-SEC Player of the Week, Tommy.
Well,
he actually won it outright.
Yeah, and again, I think they should have just kept doing the co, so we'd had something to complain about
and moan.
People to say, "Aha!" Confirms the conspiracy theory. But
yeah,
clearly, I heard very few takes and opinions on this yesterday. There's a lot more outrage and a lot more people paying attention to this award when it's co-player of the week.
Mm-hmm. I think he went 6-for-11 with 10 RBIs against LSU. Watched him hit a bomb to left field. That was pretty entertaining.
Surprised there weren't people complaining he didn't win pitcher of the week too. So even though he's a center fielder.
Yeah. So Arkansas, Danny was talking about recruiting. Recruiting nowadays to not just apply out of the high school ranks and the JUCO ranks, but grad transfers and transfers with the one-time transfer rule getting approved. Former Missouri defensive end Trey Williams has committed to Arkansas. Last season had 2 sacks this past year. He's a former Barry Odom defensive player, and another guy that you brought over along with, is it Derek Utsley? Am I saying his name?
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. You seem solid in that
yes.
response.
I'll just say
so,
yes.
Yeah. That's another play that Arkansas has pulled over from the Missouri Tigers. Now, you did get some basketball news yesterday that was reported that this looked like it was going to happen, and it was confirmed by the University of Arkansas Athletic Department that Gus Arginal has been hired as Eric Musselman's assistant coach for the Razorback basketball teams. He's got 17 years of coaching experience. He's going to join us tomorrow at 8 o'clock, and he was recently at Cal State Fullerton as an associate head coach, was also at Nevada under Eric Musselman's, been at Chico State, Rise, Cal State, East Bay, and some other programs as well, but he's going to be the newest assistant. He's going to be making $200,000 for the Arkansas basketball team.
So that gives him a little room in the budget maybe to do some things for other staff. That's less than you've been paying assistants and Corey Williams. Crutchfield, all those guys were making more than that in recent years in the last 2 transitions. So gives you some headroom with him on a salary down the road, and probably gives Coach Muss a little room to do some things for other guys on the staff as well in that salary pool.
Mm-hmm.
Not sure how that's going to work out, but that's a little bit less. That's noticeably less than what than what the last two guys on staff were making.
Yeah. Also, another quickening headline for you this morning. This will be the last one that we get to. SmackDown, did you see that the Cowboys aren't going to pick up the fifth-year option on Leighton Vander Esch? And I know we were talking about linebackers with Sean Lee retiring for the Dallas Cowboys. Well, now it doesn't look like they're going to retain him. He's going to be an unrestricted free agent next March.
I didn't see this news to answer your question, but I mean, kind of surprised. He played really well, but kind of along the same lines of Sean Lee, just injuries have killed him. Injuries have killed him, but I believe it's his neck, if I'm not mistaken. So kind of along those same lines. So I don't blame them for not picking up the option just for that, but maybe he has a good standout year, plays in all 17, right? It's bumped up from 16 to 17 now, so all 17 this year. Or plays a good healthy chunk of 15, 16, whatever. So, and who knows? Maybe the kid we got this year in the draft will be the future.
Have you guys wrapped your minds around the NFL playing 17 games yet? Does that matter to you whatsoever? It matters for us for fantasy football purposes.
I think the conversation probably sunk in a little bit more during the draft. Is, you know, you heard a lot of the, you know, that was one more angle to the build-up to the draft with Kiper or McShay or whoever else, or, you know, quoting GMs and all this stuff about, you know, can this guy hold up through 17 games? Veteran players and needing to be replaced, the 17th game was a factor in the conversation. So I think fans are probably becoming, A, more aware, and B, seeing what the ramifications of this are going to be. For season ticket holders, you'll see it as well, I guess. Will that be an every other year thing? Because you also drop a preseason game out of this deal, or preseason games. So, you know, I don't know how that's going to divide out, because 17 is obviously, you know, not an even number. So I guess every other year you'll have the extra home game.
Yeah, I guess. Last headline. This is the last headline I want to discuss. So the NFL announced yesterday that Amazon Prime Video is going to take over Thursday Night Football as the exclusive, that's the important word, exclusive home for the 2022 season, because we already had Ryan and Hot Springs asking if they'd go back and forth between Fox and the NFL Network. And I know for many of you, we have a lot of older listeners. And as a young guy, as 26 years old, I'm frustrated when Arkansas baseball, the number one team in the country, is not on the SEC Network or not on the SEC Network alternate. I have to fiddle and find them on SEC Network Plus, or when I'm at a specific bar or something, they don't have it on because you can't broadcast it that way.
They're either not set up or they don't have good enough internet.
Correct. And it's not legal to do that, right?
No, I mean, it's not illegal to do it. You can do it. It's just a lot of times the person behind the bar doesn't know how to physically put the game on when it's not on just a channel.
Are you sure that's right? I thought it was illegal for you to broadcast something that was placed on. There's some rule, Tommy, that I don't think you can do. Are you sure?
Nothing. I mean, maybe you know something I don't, okay. But I don't believe that's correct.
Because I asked, who did I ask about that? I was asking one of my buddies that manages a place, and he said that you're not supposed to be able to. It's some weird. I don't understand it, but unless you pay for the rights or whatever, I don't get it. But that's, I think this Thursday night thing is going to be interesting, because a lot of times I'll go watch a game Thursday night somewhere, and it's just going to be weird. If I know a lot of places have the capabilities with Roku and the what are the different, like, TVs? It's like with the Roku app.
I like Roku because you can add different apps to it. Where, you know, some of these other streaming boxes, Apple TV would be another one. There's not the flexibility to add. A lot of it's just built into your TV anymore. You don't buy a box now. Mm-hmm. I recently had to buy a couple of the Roku boxes, and depends on the age of your TV. But if you bought a TV in the last, 4 years, 5 years,
maybe,
yeah, it's got smart TV capabilities built in. But I prefer the Roku because you can add a lot of stuff. But apparently, you know, this Roku, you know, we always have these legal battles between like DirecTV and, you know, your local CBS station or ESPN, they'll take a channel off for a while. Apparently, YouTube TV and Roku are at it.
At odds.
And now YouTube TV's off of Roku for a little while. I don't know if they've settled that yet, but, you know, that's where we're headed next, guys. They're going to be in these kind of disputes over distribution rights and fees on these streaming platforms. But
Chris said you have to have a commercial license with your service provider. I knew there was some like stipulation that you had to do. I
don't Who's know. Enforcing that?
I mean, you could make the case. It's like the.
I guess it depends on the size of your business and your appetite for risk on that stuff. But I guess if you're a big national chain, that you might shy away from it. I imagine your local watering hole, they're not too worried about that stuff.
Yeah, and they're trying to suck up as much as
no laws much. Against playing the video, just the audio. That's anyway, this is going to become more and more prominent because, and here's the other thing. Do you have good enough internet to do it all? You know, fiber's becoming more and more prominent in more and more commercial settings.
That's a good point.
But what if you live in a rural setting and you want to watch Thursday night football and fiber's still not to where you live or high-speed internet even? I mean, we take for granted if you live in the city limits that you got cable, you got UVerse, you got something.
I'll take you boys to where I live in El Paso, Arkansas.
Yeah. What's your speed test run out there?
We don't. We don't have internet.
You don't have internet? Nothing? No DSL?
We have satellite internet. Satellite That's internet. As good as we can get. So you won't and be it is pure and utter.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I know. So you won't be watching Thursday night football because there will be no other way to do it because the frustration of the buffering will just eat you up, drive you nuts. So, but how much of that, I mean, at the end of the day, if you're sitting here and you're Roger Goodell and you're Amazon, you're Bezos, you're all these people making these decisions and investing these money, what percentage of America is that?
Lesser, but it's 5%
or whatever. But we take for granted that, you know, everybody's going to be able to get it. Well, that's not true either.
And like you mentioned, those are luxuries to some people. I would be frustrated, and I think there's always going to be people frustrated that they won't be able to watch their favorite team on Thursday night just because they've switched up just how they've gone about it.
Yeah, Kyle says Wave Rural Connect's coming in there. That's great. You know, a lot of the that's helping in our state more than you can imagine. Places like Next up in North Central Arkansas, Wave Rural Connect to the River Valley, bringing fiber to rural areas. But there's still multiple electric companies. And that's if you're on the electric cooperative, you're possibly getting this. If you're on SWEPCO or Entergy or some of these, they're not in that business. Mm-hmm. OG&E, you may live in a rural area and not have it. So, Kyle, you're right. A lot of Arkansans are getting it. I know the governor's investing a lot of money in this, but you know, just to think that everybody can stream a game, whether it's an Arkansas baseball game or an NFL game this Thursday, I think a lot of people will be able to. The question I think you're asking is, are you going to be willing to, even if you have the internet?
I think it's a combination of irritation and just the not just the irritation, but even if you know you can even do it, and that's something that I think that's the NFL is going to not just the NFL, but when you have other professional leagues and college, the NCAA and the SEC, how they're going to combat people that don't necessarily have access to that. And that's not fair, but unfortunately, we're turning in that direction.
I think. Getting internet, high-speed internet to every home is going to become like the electrification of America back in the 30s or whatever. That, you know, eventually we'll get there and everybody will have it. You guys don't get this yet, but you'll learn it, and SmackDown's learning this. When you get married, you go through the conversation on a multi-night-a-week basis.
Yes.
What do you want for dinner?
Oh,
I don't care. What do you want? Yeah. I don't care. Just go get something. That's why I love River City Bistro, because I know any night that I need to go get something. My wife says, I don't care, just go get something. I can go get her the cranberry walnut chicken salad.
She's content.
On a croissant or on the bagel crisps, either way. And
she's a happy camper.
I'm not going to be in trouble. She's going to be a happy camper. I can get the kids a burger or a sandwich, you know, BLT or a grilled cheese or a burger, and they're happy. And, hey, daddy's always going to be happy because I'm either going to get a Reuben or if I'm really hungry and get that ribeye. But that's the thing about River City Bistro. Our good friends Bruce and Michelle have a great business. If you haven't been there in a while, you may not know, they changed ownership over a year ago. So if it's been a couple, 3 years since you've been there, you haven't been there. You need to try it. Great outdoor patio dining, great dining inside, full bar service. So if you want a cocktail, you want a cold beer, you want a glass of wine, they've got a great selection. And they got a great brunch on the weekends as well. River City Bistro. The thing I love is, hey, you get that answer like I always get at my house. I don't care. Just go get something. Get to River City Bistro. You can go online and order at rcbistro.com. They do curbside pickup. They got delivery services hooked in as well. Or just stop in for a great outdoor dining or indoor dining experience at 7320 Rogers Avenue in the Stonewood Village Shopping Center.
Now, I know our residential Chiefs fan, David in South Arkansas, wants to watch every single one of his Chiefs games. What happens, David, if they're on Thursday Night Football? Are you going to be able to watch it?
I have no clue what's going to happen as far as the Thursday night thing. One of the problems I have down here in South Arkansas, of course, living out the woods, we have DirecTV. However, we only get Little Rock stations as far as CBS, ABC, and NBC. So whatever they're showing is what we're going to get. Even on Sundays, I go to my local sports bar. They've got like 20-something TVs, and they're all on one game on Sunday afternoons. I'm like, hey, there's like 8 games going on. Well, we don't have all those other games, so I'm sitting here going, great, I get to watch 20 TVs with the same game. So sometimes that can be horribly frustrating and irritating. For some reason, South Arkansas just seems to be completely ignored by Little Rock and the rest of the state. But anyway, as far as the season tickets go, the Chiefs have an extra home game this year. We have 9. That's going to be the Packers. What we did, we gave up 1 home preseason game. Next year, we'll have 8 home games and 2 preseason games. So I'm still paying for 10 tickets no matter what. And the ridiculous thing is, of course, preseason tickets are the same price as regular season. Yeah. So that's neither here nor there.
So they even up the number with a preseason game for you. Is that what's happening?
Yeah. We only have 1 home preseason game this year, and we have 9 home games regular season.
Next year it'll be two and one less. All right.
Right. So I get 10, you know, it's going to be 10 tickets no matter what. So that really doesn't affect me in any way. And I'll be honest, I love the preseason games. You don't have the horrible crowds. It's so much fun. You get to see all your friends, you know, kind of getting back into practice as, you know, just like the team does. And all the TV crews are roaming around interviewing everybody. God, our crew, we've been interviewed every year, it seems like. So that's so much fun during the preseason game. But it's frustrating as far as the TV thing. I have no clue what I'm going to do. Like I said, I live out in the woods. And it's just going to be bizarre. It's all about money. You saw what happened with the soccer fans over in England when that big league tried to get going. And I think at some point, the fans here in this country are just going to have to step up and go, come on, people, quit screwing us over like this. You know, we're fans. That team, those players have been there for a short period of time. That team has been there since before these players, before these people. It's just ridiculous the way we keep getting the shaft. But that's a wholly, totally different story. So, anyway, thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
As long as you keep giving them your money, they have no reason to change.
That's a good point. Yeah. We did get a good text here, I thought. Let's see. Is NCA Hog from Yellville talking about, as far as streaming the baseball games, and this ties into the NFL conversation, he likes to at least to have the capability that you could stream 95% of the games, where years ago you'd be lucky to only see a couple. And the SEC Network has made a lot of things better, but in this situation, in Thursday Night Football, it's typically not a marquee game, but for David and other Chiefs and other fans, it's got to be frustrating for those that don't have the ability to get their favorite team's game.
No one would have ever watched a softball game this year if it wasn't for streaming services.
Good point.
Keep that in mind. I mean, all of these other sports, you wouldn't have seen most of the games you've watched on TV with baseball as a result. All right, Clay Henry coming up in just a few minutes on the other side of the break. Tomorrow, Brett Goode joins us. We'll talk some more football and the NFL draft and some Aaron Rodgers news. He's part of the winning team at Henderson Phillips Employer Solutions. If you're worried about insurance this morning, commercial or personal, call Brett 479-651-2292. He can walk you through the myriad of options when it comes to insurance needs, also employee benefits, health insurance for your staff, staffing management solutions, and more. It's Brett Goode, Henderson Phillips Employer Solutions, 651-2292. Clay Henry next on the Morning Rush.
Wheels RV in Springdale wants you to seek out all the natural state has to offer this year. Explore Arkansas in a new RV from Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, or Alliance. All the best brands at the best prices. Enjoy peace of mind with our lifetime warranty on every new RV and a mobile service shuttle to keep you camping. So come on in and discover why Wheels RV was voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. 5 miles west of I-49, exit 72.
Seek, explore, discover with Wheels RV.
Hi, I'm Bill Bolton of NWA Gold, Silver, and Coins. I started in this business in 1972 at an auction house that specialized in antique and estate jewelry, sterling silver, and coins. In that time, I've seen gold go from $35 an ounce to today's price of $1,683. I want to talk to you about the coins you may have inherited and how important it is to deal with someone who understands coins and this market. In 2011, we had a mother and daughter come into our store and sell us a lot of jewelry they no longer wore for $3,300. The daughter then pulled out an 1850 California $10 gold piece. Jeremy offered her $900, and she accepted his offer. He then advised her to have this coin graded. She did, and she sold it for $36,000. If you don't know what you have, please come see Jeremy in our Bentonville store. Don't sell at an auction or an estate sale and get less money. What's in your safety deposit box could be worth thousands. NWA Gold, Silver, and Coins, Bentonville, Fayetteville.
Tommy Kraft here for The Fence Man, the company you can trust when it comes to building your next fence. The Fence Man recently built new gates for my existing fence. The whole process was easy, quick, and most importantly, affordable. Plus, 18-month same-as-cash financing with approved credit is now available with The Fence Man. If you need a new fence, gate, or anything that involves a fence, call The Fence Man, 479-782-3936. That's 782-3936. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. River City Bistro is Fort Smith's favorite place for lunch, dinner, and brunch. Open 7 days a week, both on the heated patio and the cozy dining room. River City Bistro is locally owned and open weekdays 11 to 8, Saturdays 10 to 8, and Sundays 10 to 3. Want River City Bistro curbside to go? Just search on Facebook or Instagram for River City Bistro or go to rcbistro.com. River City Bistro, 7320 Rogers Avenue in the Stonewood Village Shopping Center.
Give potted plants a healthy start with Scott's Miracle-Gro from Metters Lumber True Value. Right now, choose a 4-pound bag of all-purpose plant food or a 2-cubic-foot bag of potting mix for just $8.99 each after $3 instant rebate for True Value Rewards members. The plant food instantly feeds flowers, vegetables, and houseplants, while the potting mix offers 6 months of continuous feeding. Shop right now for these and other great bargains of the month while supplies last at Metters Lumber True Value. Certain exclusions apply. See store for details.
Hey, Grounds Guys.
Hey, what?
Can you clean up my yard?
You betcha. That's what the Grounds Guys are here for. Grounds Guys will clean up any of that lingering winter debris like leaves and branches, prep your lawn for spring, and give your flower beds a fresh new look. Grounds Guys is your one-stop shop for all your lawn care needs in Northwest Arkansas and the Fort Smith area. Call 479-303-GUYS. That's 303-G-U-Y-S. Or visit groundsguys.com. The Grounds Guys. Leave the yard work to us.
Your husband is pretty handy to have around. He makes the world's best mac and cheese. He's in the Tickle Monster Hall of Fame. And he can teach anyone how to throw strikes. But a busted pipe and a basement full of water?
Honey, I think we need a plumber.
He's a little out of his league. That's where a homeowner's policy from Shelter Insurance comes in handy. We'll help get your house back in order and your husband back to what he does best.
Ask Shelter agents Brandon Zimmerman or Chris Dooley about a free insurance review.
It's spring cleaning sale time at Jelco Outdoors. Save up to 75% off on selected clothing items. Summer and winter clothing for men, women, and children. Look for the orange clearance stickers with racks lined with savings. Footwear and archery items are included in the big spring clearance sale, going on now until it's gone. The boss says let's clear the racks during the spring cleaning sale at Jelco Outdoors. 4600 South Zero in Fort Smith.
This is Bruce Stanton, Vice President and General Manager of Pradco Fishing in Fort Smith. Our number one volume lure out of our 20 fishing brands is the Bobby Garland Baby Shad. We make them by the millions in our facility in Fort Smith, and the Baby Shad is without a doubt the number one soft plastic crappie lure in the U.S. Fish it on a light jig head or underneath a float, and you'll find it's as productive as live bait. Available at Walmart, Bass Pro Shops, Academy, LureNet.com, and tackle stores all over the place, the Bobby Garland Baby Shad.
I chose Anchley Air just because I've always wanted to work for the best. I asked a lot of folks at my church who the best heat and air company is, and 90% of the people I talked to said Anchley was the best. So I wanted to work for the best.
Great things are happening at Anchley Air. We're looking for skilled service and installation technicians for our Fort Smith and Northwest Arkansas locations. We're willing to pay the right person up to $5,000 in hiring bonuses. To apply online, visit our website at AnchleyAir.com.
AnchleyAir.com.
ESPN Arkansas weather.
For today, cold front will march on through. Chance of showers and thunderstorms with that front. Also, some cooler air will be galloping on in. We're going to see temperatures across the north falling into the upper 50s, falling into the upper 60s across the south. A colder night, overnight lows in the 40s. I'm Sally Russell with your forecast on ESPN Arkansas.
Check out the Fish City Grill Ruskin and Zach podcast on hitthatline.com or search Hit That Line wherever you listen to podcasts. You're listening to The Morning Rush, live from the Busch Light Studios on ESPN 95.3, KERX Paris Fort Smith. This hour of The Morning Rush is brought to you by the Smithwick Original Suspending Rattlin' Rogue. Available at Walmart, Bass Pro Shops, Academy, LureNet.com, and tackle stores all over the place.
Called strike three. It's over. From one win 5 years ago to number one in the SEC in 2021, the Razorbacks have their first SEC championship.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios. Bush.
You are causing a major disturbance on my time.
If I'm here and you're here, doesn't that make it our time?
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station. Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
There's a lot of lions, tigers, and bears, but they ain't but one Razorback. Number one.
This is The Morning Rush.
Borderline erotic.
With Ty Richardson.
I'm Ty.
That's cool. I can dig it.
And Tommy Kraft.
Do I look happy?
What's wrong?
Lloyd!
The Morning Rush starts right now.
It's hour number two of The Morning Rush on a Toyota Tuesday. Now, we haven't talked a lot of Arkansas softball this year, but when you win and share the SEC title, and they can win it outright if Florida drops one of the remaining three games that they'll play this weekend. But you have to give Courtney Dyfel and her group of girls credit for doing something that's been never, ever done in Razorback softball history. We'll touch on that with Clay Henry, the publisher of Hogs Illustrated, coming up.
I want to tell you about our good friends at Dobson Fiber, formerly known as Pinnacle Telecom. Dobson now has an expanded, larger network to help take care of you and your business and bring you business telephone solutions, high-speed internet solutions with fiber to the door. Several years ago, this great company brought fiber, buried it in the ground, brought it into our studio building, and it was game-changing for our operation. We got the same amount of upload speed on our internet as we do download speed. And when you're in the, you know, into uploading podcasts and videos and all of the things we do, it is very important for our day-to-day business operations. So if you're struggling with reliable service and a great company to work with when there's ever an issue, you need our friends at Dobson Fiber. 479-242-0000. That's 242-0000 for Dobson Fiber.
I have just one question for you.
Oldie,
are you ready?
I'm ready for this my whole life.
Welcome to the most incredible 2 hours of your life. Here he is. The Clay Henry.
You have to blow the dust off that?
I was going to say, we haven't used that in a while. I just felt like switching up.
Are you still worthy of that?
No, probably not. I did get my little fake drums, air drums out and beat them, so, you know.
There you go.
Boom, 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 boom.
Heard that in a while.
Are you, Claire, are you joining us this weekend, by the way?
Well, I guess I would have to know what you're talking about to say whether I am or not.
Wow.
No. Clay didn't want to come with us.
Uh-oh. Are y'all going fishing or golfing?
Both, well, right? Maybe both. I'll call you later about the golfing part. You're probably more interested in the golfing than the fishing.
Hey, you know what? I'm gonna be a good brother here, and I'm only gonna play 9 holes on Friday so I can go to my little sister's graduation so I can get out.
That's probably a good idea.
Is that qualify for?
Yeah, we got a little half day of you wouldn't want to go fishing. See, Clay fly fishes. We're gonna put worms and shrimp and corn. Clay doesn't want any part of that, so he's not gonna fish with us.
Well. Now, if it turns out that there's good eating involved, I'm talking about the fish, if you're going to keep some crappie or something like that, now that's a whole different deal.
No, we're going trout fishing, so I know you'd turn. If the thought even crossed someone's mind of keeping
the
trout, you'd
do that. You buy your license, you get to fish however you want to, that's fine, but it isn't sport.
Well, I'm not interested in that.
I will say I was looking at the itinerary, and I didn't see anything about a bar or drinking or other.
Well, everybody else's did. That will be. I sent you a different itinerary.
Ty, that will just be spontaneous.
I did.
It'll just break out. Yeah.
I did appreciate the this itinerary. Tommy had said all the women, or it said all the men and Ty will be.
I was explaining the accommodations. We got a mixed group going with some of our female staff and some of our men, and Ty are going. So I said the ladies would have their own place to stay at Gaston's, and the men and Ty would stay in another building. That's the way I worded that.
Pull a Mike Gundy and say, I'm a man, I'm 26. I have hair on my chest and hair in other places that needs to be hairy, but I think we're going to have a good old time. Clay, I'd love to see you this weekend. I know you wouldn't love to see me.
We're going to do a half a day, and then we're going to go over to Big Creek and play some golf. So maybe you want to join us for that.
The Big Creek golf stuff, that sounds interesting. I'm all into golf now.
I'll tell you about that.
You think Chuck would join us for that?
Probably not.
Probably not. No. Actually, he's not. I say that. He's not. He'll be coming back in a little bit. He's got, a week or so. But Clay, this softball team, man, Courtney Dyfel's squad, I mean, you think about what she inherited, what she took over, and now – 5 years later to be where they are as the at least sharing the regular season SEC title, which, by the way, guys, Florida and Alabama are the only ones that have won it since 2007. So they're in very unique territory.
Been a top-heavy league.
Yeah, not just for Arkansas softball, but just the SEC overall. Clay, how much – actually, you ask it.
Well, I would just say, you know, she's been on the job 6 years, Clay. I mean, I just want to – we got about 4 minutes. I want to leave you enough time to give – Jeff Long credit for this great hire here with Courtney Dyfel.
Well, 4 minutes may not be enough. So, Jeff Long, you give him the blame for some of his hires, but he didn't dabble in anything but football or basketball. I mean, somebody else hired her, and he didn't know where she was from. I mean,
did he know how to spell Dyfel?
I doubt it, and I mean, it's just... I don't want to give him credit for anything other than getting fired. How's that?
Okay, so no credit for the softball success.
No. I don't think that's. I would not think that would be appropriate, Tommy.
Okay, I thought you might have an opinion on that subject.
Just yeah. One different. Is he still at Kansas?
He got fired in Kansas about a month and a half ago.
About that hire as he did about Snoop Dogg when they came to Kansas. He did not know there would be pole dancing.
What they call
sure.
it? Artistic. What was the phrase they used there, Ty?
Artistic dance. That's got to be
artistic dance. Something.
It was PR nightmare.
It was not pole dancing. That's not what they called it. But that's what it was.
How do you spin
those brass or stainless steel poles? Did anyone ask? You know.
How do you spin that if you're a PR person?
Well, I'm talking about the girls climb up and they spin around. That's how. That's
Jeff
what
Long
was going
deal right there. Yeah. But back to softball here. I could clean this up. You know. It's part of the rising tide on campus that, you know, we're seeing the success in a lot of the sports that generally don't get a lot of attention because, quite honestly, there hadn't been a lot of success. But you're seeing soccer success that has been maintained and sustained. I guess, you know, and I find it interesting, the people that are watching softball. I talk to, you know, some buddies of mine a little older than me, you know, guys in their 50s and 60s that are making appointments with themselves to watch these games on the streaming, you know, on the app. And I find it interesting who has found this season to be interesting and entertaining to them and made appointments to watch it this year. Yeah, it's gaining a fan base, no doubt.
Well, it's, you know, home runs are fun. I'll just tell you, just straight out fun. And they do hit home runs, and I think Oklahoma hits more, but that's it. That, you know, and you know, it's. I got to know last spring. You know, sat down with Kayla Green, the catcher who has the unique story. Grew up, basically raised herself in Southern California. Had an father was in prison, absentee mom. She was institutionalized too, and she raised her and a younger brother. By herself when she was 16 years old. Just think about that. So I've been kind of keeping up with her and the team, and it's just so much fun. And they win. I mean, and they win a lot. And they, it's kind of like the guys. You know, they're never out of a game. They come back with a home run, and they play defense. So yeah, a lot of fun, and there are a lot of people watching them right now.
877-377-6963 is the number that you can call or text. And we'll get Clay's thoughts on what we were discussing earlier, this whole Thursday night football moving to Amazon Prime Video. Hey, what about what's the most sellable program on this campus right now? What's the easiest to market if you're Hunter Yurchek in that athletic department? That's next on the Morning Rush.
This is Toyota Tuesday on the Morning Rush. Get by your local Toyota dealer for a test drive today. Toyota, let's go places.
Hi, it's Jan from Toyota. Summer's finally here, and with a great deal on a new Camry, RAV4, Highlander, Tacoma, and more, you can celebrate all of your favorite summer holidays, like Memorial Day, Cinco de Mayo, Independence Day, Father's Day.
You're doing great, Jan.
Thanks, Dad. Love you. International Pizza Party Day. Pepperoni, please. And by pepperoni, I mean Hawaiian. Let's keep this between us, though. I have relatives in Boston. I'll take another slice of pepperoni, please. But hold the pepperoni, and let's go ahead and add ham and pineapple. Thanks.
Kick off summer at your Toyota dealer, where you can save big on all your favorites like Camry, RAV4, Highlander, Tacoma, and more. But this event ends June 1st. See your participating Toyota dealer today. Toyota, let's go places.
Hey, Ty Richardson for Shangri-La Resort. The Carr family would like to thank all of our customers over the last 40 years that have made Shangri-La home. We've had so many return visitors over the years, and that's thanks to you. Do you need a place to take the family for vacation? Or how about a work trip? Or just a day on the water? Shangri-La Resort is the place to call. Give the Carr family a ring at 870-867-2011 at Shangri-La Resort. Check out Shangri-La Resort online at shangrilaresort.net. Shangri-La Resort, a touch of paradise and a boatload of fun.
Was your roof damaged by recent storms? Don't fall victim to out-of-town contractors and fly-by-night repairmen. Trust the local roofing professionals at Able Roofing. Call their local number, 474-0006, for a free roof inspection. Never trust something as important as the roofing system on your home to a storm chaser. Able Roofing, 474-0006, will work with your insurance company. Call now for your free roof inspection, 474-0006. Able Roofing, the hometown roofers.
There's more to a tractor than just horsepower. A tractor also needs weight to get that horsepower to the ground. With TYM, a heavier tractor comes standard. Many of the TYM models weigh more for the horsepower than comparable tractors from the big names. And tractors that weigh more do more. See Bush Tractor at their new location at 6100 South Zero in Fort Smith. Or log on to bushtractor.com to see how they can upgrade your productivity.
Farm Credit has been a trusted friend for over 100 years. They are ag financing experts. So whether you're a longtime farmer, new to farming, or buying your dream home or land in the country, their experienced staff has a plan to fit your goals, needs, and your bottom line. From farms to land, livestock, equipment, and more, Farm Credit finances it all. Learn more at myaglender.com. Farm Credit is an equal opportunity lender.
The Gold Nut has a great selection of shoes arriving weekly. Choose from Nike, FootJoy, Echo, Under Armour, New Balance, Asics, Puma, and Adidas. While you're there, pick up a hat or check out the wide selection of apparel and accessories. Need golf balls? In stock now, the new TaylorMade TP5s or the Titleist Pro V1 or Pro V1X golf balls. Check Facebook for daily specials and new arrivals. The Gold Nut, 5121 Towson Avenue in Fort Smith, your number one golf shop since 1994.
Riley Farm Dental, at the entrance to Riley Farms, provides every type of dental care and procedures for you and your family. From general dentistry, braces, implants, and cosmetics, Dr. Bo Sparkman and Dr. Brogan give all of their patients better lives with a better smile, more confidence, and a comfortable experience every time. Riley Farm Dental, 5901 Riley Park Drive, Suite A, at the entrance to Riley Farms. Call 226-3500 for an appointment or visit RileyFarmDental.com.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house?
All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
Do you own apartment complexes, condos, and rental property? Then you have made a great investment. Now make another great decision by calling Trinity Multifamily to help you maximize your return. Trinity Multifamily offers full-service property management, marketing, leasing, sales, and all the services to make your cash flow. Take the hassles and frustrations out of ownership and call Trinity Multifamily at 479-452-1817 or online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
Locally owned Lumber One can handle all of your building needs. They've built their business on having great relationships with everybody from contractors and builders to the everyday build-it-yourself. Lumber One is a full-line door shop to handle all of your door, window, and trim needs. And along with lumber, roofing and drywall products, attic wall and floor insulation is available. Lumber One also does blueprint takeoff with access to design services with estimates available. So go where the pros go. Lumber One, located on Industrial Park Road in Van Buren.
ESPN 95.3. The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Crabb.
Swung on, belted by Wallace to deep left field. Back it goes. Out of here! Two-run homer, Caden Wallace. What a moment for the freshman.
Follow the show on Twitter at HitThatLineAR and on Facebook and Instagram at HitThatLine.
Toyota Tuesday edition of the Morning Rush. Welcoming in our guy, Bruce Stan of Pradco Fishing, who has once again graced us with some
Clay
gifts
Clay Yottis, I may or may not take this one to Clay.
Rebel Pop-R.
Yep. Clay's worked good on the lake.
It's all good, man.
Or in the pond at Big Creek, one or the other.
It will, anything that you give me, anything, you know, I know that that last batch of stuff you picked through and then mm-hmm. gave me the stuff you didn't want.
Absolutely.
But that's okay.
Yeah. Which of these colors are probably better this time of year?
I would use that blue back.
Use the blue one, or I'll keep the blue one and give the
give
other
him
one
the baby
Clay.
Bath. Yeah. So he done aced you, Clay.
So, Bruce, here's how this needs to go down in the future. I'll send you some stuff directly. You send me stuff directly.
We'll just deal direct. Cut out the distributor.
Yeah, we we need to eliminate the middleman, because the middleman middleman is the boss and takes what he wants.
I'm just deducting the delivery fees out of there, you know.
Yeah.
Shipping and handling fee, Clay.
How this went down is he gave me this stuff. He goes, I really don't know what that stuff is. So, you know, he picked out the stuff that he knew what it was. Mm-hmm. So
I've been doing this 3 months. I know there's been at least a couple hundred lures set aside for you. If you only got 15.
Don't tell him about the rod and reels.
As far as lures go, I've gotten one real lure. There's been one. There was one.
Did I leave one in
there?
And
he's like, I don't know about that one.
I didn't mean to leave one in there. Yeah. That was by accident. I thought I got them all out.
A little kit for crappie, you know, the
Bobby Garland.
Yeah, I got one of the. But now Christopher says we need the white or the milky monk or something like that.
Monkey
he said
milk.
We need that. Yeah, monkey milk. So and I think that may be over for right now because the lake's jumped up so big. But
just keep following them. That they keep going up the bank right now. Get behind the trees and the bushes up on the picnic tables. Throw that pawpaw and you'll catch.
Yeah, Christopher has the what do you call it? The little screen where you see them and you watch them eat. We'll find them. Yeah,
yeah.
Got him a Garmin or a Lowrance up there showing him what it is.
It's pretty cool. Yeah, it's like playing video games. Yeah.
Before we get to the other sports in the world, I know fishing's been. I've been amazed just paying a little more attention to my Facebook feed, Twitter feed. How many listeners have started interacting with us about what they're doing. I know you were down at Broken Bow last week fishing down there. I've been just amazed just following, and I guess if you're kind of new to this, you just go bass fishing when someone invites you, kind of like what I've been doing this last couple of weeks, how big that is. I was in a business that was going through a remodel process, and they needed a drop ceiling put in, and the guy said, well, It's not going to happen until next week. Those guys have all taken off to go bass fishing. Can you believe it? They're bass fishing this week.
I love them people. And what pays the bill.
Exactly right. So
those are your people.
That's it, my people.
I hope you had a great time. I know it's not over yet, but I know last week or so, last 10 days have been a big time. And I know a lot of our listeners have sent us pictures and engaged with us on social media about it and really enjoyed it. I've been, Ty, you've got them. I've got them, these pictures of, you know, guys catching them on Yum Dingers and all, you know, Smithwicks and all kinds of Yum, you know, all sorts of stuff that we talk about. That's been fun to see that here on the show.
It is. It's the magic time of year when you get up on the bank and the fish are spawning, the bass are spawning, and the white bass are post-spawn, walleye are post-spawn. Everybody's up on the bank eating little bitty shad, and we got them schooling just about every day. We get white bass and largemouth and smallmouth all schooling together, and then, you know, you throw a jig head on a point and catch a walleye, and of course you eat those things. But it's a magic time, the full moon in April, and with the weather we've had, it's actually good. You can get on the lake like 10 killer right here. Most of the ramps are 10 feet underwater right now, but if you can back off the road and get your boat in, go fish around state parks, picnic tables, trees, way up on the bank, and the bass, they keep going up to eat, and you just chase them with a Yum Dinger or that Pawpaw I gave you this morning, and you can still catch them. But it is a great time, and it'll be a great time for the next several weeks.
Yeah. So, well, thanks for filling up our tackle boxes this year. It's been a lot of fun so far, just talking about it and learning a little bit more about it. But we've been talking about, you know, You're in the marketing business. You market all these variety of products and market, you know, the fun of fishing. I mean, that's really what, at the end of the day, you're talking about how fun it is to get your kids, to get your buddies, and go out and have a good time. And you make it easier to have a good time because people want to go catching, not fishing. And we were talking about just the marketability with the softball team capturing an SEC title for the first time ever last night, and the marketability of the various programs up there last night. We were talking about just the interesting angles of now with the streaming services. I find it interesting engaging in conversations with people you never thought would be interested in the softball program that have watched 20 games this year, whatever, on that. The marketability of these programs right now and what the softball team has done has been pretty interesting.
Well, D1 softball is exciting. I'm a Tennessee fan, so we had Monica Abbott several years ago and played for a College World Series, lost best two or three versus Arizona, but it is exciting. It's played on a little league field, basically. Everything's fast. There's a lot of speed, a lot of power. And, yeah, you watch the OU women, they're knocking it out of the park. Alabama are knocking it out of the park. You know, there's certain games at a high level, which are just any sport at a high level is fun to watch. And you watch these top 20 women's softball programs, like Arkansas is in that game now. They got a beautiful park up in Fayetteville, and it's exciting to watch, especially when your school's winning or your team's winning. So you know, if you haven't given softball a chance, you know, now's the time to see Arkansas play at a high level. And the SEC has really come up. It used to be the Pac-10, used to be all California teams winning championships, and you know, the SEC is starting to become a power and softball like it is so many other sports, and you're starting to see a lot of West Coast players, and you're starting to see players from the Southeast develop into D1 players. So it's a good time. If you want to see something different and see something at a high level, go watch the Lady Razorbacks play some softball.
Yeah. What's the most sellable sport up there, Clay? What's the easiest sport to sell right now?
Well, I think there's a bunch of them. You know, I mean, I think Arkansas baseball is pretty sellable. I think basketball has been like that. And of course, there's, you know, the marketing opportunities for football are just so much bigger. I mean, the money is bigger. Those sponsorships are huge. And I think they're able to market Sam Pittman and what they're doing in football. But yeah, I think it might start with, baseball right now.
Yeah.
And, you know, you don't want to have your other programs such that you call yourself a baseball school, but that's what Arkansas was for a few years there. You know, basketball was down, football was down, but Dave Van Horn hasn't ever been down. I guess they had one year where they where they didn't have pitching, but that's about it.
What was that? 2014, they missed the tournament, and I think that's the only year. I think it was 2014 that he didn't make the tournament, but and then came back the next year and made the College World Series. I think I got my years right. I know 15 was a College World Series year. I think 14 the year prior to that's been the only year in his time. There's only been one, but you know, you think about the perfect storm for, you know, and Ty's question this morning was most sellable. It's when you have particularly that in-state athlete you can kind of build around and become the face of the program, but so much of the time in college sports, the coach is the person, Bruce, that you kind of center things around. And as these secondary sports, and I hate to even label them that, but they are. They're in the shadows of football, basketball. Baseball still lives kind of somewhat in the shadows of that, even though it's enjoying a lot of on-field success. It'd be interesting to see how they can bring those out into the light a little bit more and make Courtney Dyfel more of a star in this state, Colby Hale more of a star in this state, more of a household name to make these sports more popular.
Well, I think if you're getting into it, or if you're not high on the tier at football and basketball, and you know you want a good experience, you know, go to a women's basketball game or a softball game, and you can sit up front, and you can be closer to the action, and you can see a really good product. I mean, Coach Neighbors had a great product. Only team that beat Connecticut during the regular season in basketball this year, and if you watched them play on TV, it was a high level of basketball. It's unfortunate, you know, they got upset in the NCAA tournament. I think they had a good enough team to make a deep run, but you know, there's a lot of, we always talk about all sports programs, and you know Arkansas, it does have an all sports program, and you know, it's a lot like Tennessee right now. Probably football's at the bottom of the list, and that's the one that brings in the most people. So I think just as creatures of habit, we always want to just go see what we're familiar with, but you know, sometimes it's good to branch out, and you might like what you see. I guarantee a lot of football fans have never been to a softball game or a women's basketball game, and I think it's just human nature. We get caught up in it. But, you know, you go to Northside or County Line or Fayetteville girls game, I mean, it's a lot of times it's a higher level of competition than the boys game, just because there's so much good coaching and so many good athletes that are playing. And I think you're seeing that on the women's side at Arkansas. Just fans traditionally don't go watch that.
So, Clay, how does Arkansas spin this forward into football? Because to me, that's the interesting thing, is you built a new stadium that's never been full. I mean, since the latest renovation, COVID played a part in that. You got Texas coming in, which should be a game that you think automatically would sell out just based on the name. How do you propel some of this momentum right now to ensure that football sees some of this success this year? Can you fill this stadium? A, will you be allowed to fill the stadium up, do you think, this fall? And B, can they sell enough tickets to fill the stadium up?
Well, September 11th is Texas, and it's not a must win. You know, you don't have to win it. But if you do win it, I think you'll see that sport take off, just because of the buying power of people like me that know what Texas used to mean. It doesn't mean that to, you know, the lion's share of the, you know, the Ty Richardsons and, you know, the people of that age. They didn't grow up with Texas as the barometer, but we did, me and Bruce and others. And I'm not saying Bruce is old, but he's older. But it's so.
I'm kind of right in the middle on that. I watched it as a teenager, but in 92, I'm still in high school, and we transitioned to the SEC, and there's no more Texas every year, you know.
But beating Texas in that part of the year will really add a lot of momentum. And, you know, you can do it with some other SEC wins, too. And, you beat LSU or, you know, some of the others. But, you know, it was, you know, really sad last year when they had early momentum and they couldn't pack the stadium, because I think they would have, you know, after that – you know, the Tennessee game, you know, they probably would have packed it for Tennessee, because, I mean, Tennessee would have brought some fans, and I think, you know, that would have been close to a sellout, and you would have a lot of momentum, people that saw that third quarter. Not Bruce, but, you know, everybody else. Yeah.
So what is the appetite right now for fans that are on the brink of buying season tickets or tickets this year for Arkansas football? Clay, do they have to see the Razorbacks beat Texas in order for them to push the money into the pot and say they're all in, or is this one of those things?
Well, I just said that. Yeah, I mean, I think that's the momentum that they need. There has to be a tipping, you know, point. It's, you know, there has to be something, you know, something magical, you know, and it could be some other game, but that one would do it. And Texas is, you know, down, but they're not as down as when Arkansas beat them in Houston. I think that, you know, there are other sports that you know, are on the edge of just taking off too. Basketball is right there. I'm telling you, you know, the run to the Elite Eight and, you know, we talked a little bit, you know, in the last segment about, you know, sellability and marketability. Eric Musselman is a marketing genius. I mean, his ability to use social media to always stay out there is got to be a treat for, you know, the marketing arm at the U of A, because he's doing it for them, and then they can just kind of spin off of that.
Well, I think there has to be something compelling to get people back. Not only are you talking about a program that hadn't been winning, but obviously with COVID, we all learned to do different things. I mean, 11 million people bought fishing licenses last year that didn't buy them the year before. Kayaks, you couldn't buy a kayak for about 6 months last year.
Golf is the same way.
Hunting, golf, running, hiking, camping were all at all-time highs. And all that meant all them people weren't going to football games last year. Mm-hmm. So what are you going to do to put that butt in that seat and make those people quit doing those participation sports and make them go back to watching something? I think it's going to be a harder deal for programs like Tennessee and Arkansas, because they got to do something compelling to make people change what they've been doing.
When it's easier than ever to not go to the game, still watch the game. You don't even have to be at home.
Yes.
Now to watch the game.
If you don't even have to be.
You can watch it on your phone.
Right here. Right. Yeah, you can be fishing or camping and listen to it or watch it.
That's makes it easier. Hey, before you go, just some thoughts from you, and we'll get some from Clay later on. NFL draft, SEC dominates once again in the draft. Arkansas had one draft selection this year as part of the SECs in 26 straight years, but how did the draft go in your mind? I know you're a Washington fan. You were probably watching it from that angle, but what were your overall thoughts and opinions on the draft last week?
Well, I mean, obviously it's impressive to see so many draft picks come out of the SEC in the first round, and overall blew away all the other conferences. But again, being a Tennessee fan, living in Arkansas, when I see Kentucky has six people drafted in the NFL draft, Tennessee has two and Arkansas has one, I think that pretty much sums it up. You know, you've got Kentucky on the rise, a program that's been a doormat, and they're recruiting talent that's getting drafted in the first round all the way through the seventh round. And I think Tennessee had Josh Palmer and Trey Smith drafted in the third and sixth round. Obviously, Arkansas had as many draft picks as the University of Central Arkansas. So, you know, I think we're all optimistic, we're hopeful, but the draft don't lie. You know, you take the best players. It's not about whose dad they are or where they came from. It's about, can you play in the NFL and cut it? And right now, Tennessee and Arkansas aren't recruiting the type of players, at least to this point, that can cut it.
Should fans be more impressed with the three wins last year, playing 10 SEC games, seeing the result in just the one draft selection? Should be more impressed with the job the coaches did, knowing that, hey, you thought you weren't overrun with NFL talent. Now you know you weren't last year.
No, I think they should be very impressed. I mean, Arkansas, you could say, should have been 5-5, a couple of calls go the wrong way. And, I think our Arkansas fans should be extremely positive that you finished 3-7 and could have been 5-5 or 6-4 in an all-SEC schedule, especially against that type of talent.
All right, Bruce Stanton, go ahead, Clay.
Well, I was just going to say, you have to kind of look at the roster and say, you know, the upperclassmen that were recruited by Bielema and Morris, there aren't any draft picks there, but there are some NFL players on the Arkansas roster. They just weren't draftable this year, because Jalen Catalan's going to be drafted next year. You know, this will be his third year. I think that, you know, Treylon Burks will be drafted high. You know, it's Myron Cunningham is going to be an NFL player, and So I think Mike Woods was on the roster last year. He'll be drafted at some point. You know, it's not going to be from Arkansas, but he was developed in Arkansas. So there were more NFL players on the Arkansas roster last year than there have been in several years. So, but yeah, that's the barometer. You know, if you don't have NFL players, you don't have pros. You know, same thing. You don't have pros. You know, Eric Musselman doesn't have pros. If Mike Nabors doesn't have pros, then he's going to suffer. But the good news is there's more pros on the Arkansas campus. There's pros on the soccer team. There are a ton of pros on the baseball team. That's the engine that makes it go.
All right, Bruce Stanton with us every Tuesday. Pradco Fishing, if someone's making plans to get to Pin Killer, Beaver, Table Rock, Norfolk, Bull Shoals this week, give them some tips. Give them some advice for this weekend.
Yeah, I think it's top water time. Look for the push water, that clear water, that muddy water is pushing out toward the dam or in the pockets. You're going to throw a Rebel Pop-R or a heading Super Spook Junior, heading Torpedo, and just beat the banks. Anything green in the water, throw around it. Just as a word of caution, please stay off the main river. Arkansas River's at flood stage. If you're going to Dardanelle, stay in Big Piney, Illinois Bayou. If you're going to Kerr, go to Salisaw Creek. Just stay off the main river. It's dangerous. A lot of big floating logs and debris coming down. So be safe. Beat the banks. Throw topwater baits.
All these things that Bruce is talking about, you can find at Walmart, Bass Pro Shops, Bass Pro Shops Academy, LureNet.com. Great place to start to see everything in the lineup.
Yeah, we got a new Norman Speed in a special color, only 300 available, and you can probably see it this week and next week. They'll be all gone, LureNet.com.
All right, or at your favorite tackle shop, you can find all this stuff. Good to see you again. Glad you had a fun time last week.
Appreciate it. And Brett Good needs to tell us what Aaron Rodgers is going to do tomorrow. I'm going to be listening.
He'll be with us about this same time tomorrow. So if he doesn't have the scoop, what's going on? He needs to be burning up the phone texting, right?
He needs to be talking to him right now. So, he needs to be going to the Washington football team.
Is he going to stay or is he going to go? Yeah, you'd take him, wouldn't you?
I'd take him right now.
Yeah, all right. Bruce Stanton with us here every Tuesday on the Morning Rush is talking a little Razorback football, the draft, a lot of stuff going on here as we visit here on this Tuesday. So.
Yeah, I'm curious, Bruce, what ends up happening with that saga, but we don't know. So I with Rodgers, we were talking about this yesterday. If he just ends up doing anything, like if he ends up being a Packer, if he ends up going to Jeopardy, I don't know what route he's going to take. I don't think Brett knows. If Brett knows, I'll be happy.
I think this right now comes down to, are they going to fire the GM or get rid of Aaron Rodgers? I mean, that seems to be the standoff we're in right now.
Seems to be the way it's going, and Rodgers is a Packer for the ages. I mean, he's loved by fans, and there's just been a rift there between him and management. Don't know what it is, but I think he's the type of guy that if he didn't get what he wanted, he'd sit out a year. I could see that happening.
So, been a while since the MVP hadn't played for the same team the next year.
Brett Good, tell us what's going to happen.
All right, we'll find out tomorrow. Good to see you, man.
Good to see y'all.
All right, lots still to get to here on the Morning Rush. We've got some headlines that we're going to come back to here. Christian Franklin ends up winning SEC Player of the Week, which I know a lot of you are excited about him not being co-Player of the Week. What's going on with the potential movement of Thursday Night Football to Amazon Prime? How's that going to affect you as a NFL fan? And this is not just going to be NFL related. It's going to be a lot of different sports leagues, college, professional. You're going to see some changes in the coming years on how you consume media. And it's going to irritate and it's going to frustrate you, which I understand because I just like watching it on the TV like a lot of you. So how that's going to affect that, we've given a lot of credit to this Arkansas softball team this morning doing what they did, sharing their first regular season SEC title in the history of the program. They could win the whole thing if Florida drops one this weekend.
All right, looking forward to a trip to Gaston's later this week. Spend some time with the crew, and no better place to get a work crew together like we're doing, small group, less than 10 of us, than at Gaston's. And they got all kinds of accommodations to accommodate your group. Great restaurant to take care of the meals. So you don't have to worry about handling that or finding restaurants or taking care of that part of the agenda. It's all right there on the grounds at Gaston's, and they got great guides. And I know that our group's going to have a great time fishing. We got several in our group that have never been trout fishing before, some that have never been fishing before, but they are looking forward to a great time. They've heard us talking about it, and the guides will do a great job of teaching and showing them exactly what to do and making sure that They have a great experience in their time on the White River. That sounds like the place for you. Call Gaston's and make your reservation, 870-431-5202. Gaston's White River Resort, a first-class time. Every time.
This is Toyota Tuesday on the Morning Rush. Get by your local Toyota dealer for a test drive today. Toyota, let's go places.
Cash and carry savings during the month of May at Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. Above ground pools started just $19.99. Check out the semi-in-ground pools starting at $99.97. Plus special savings on chemical packages to get your pool off to the right start this summer. Cash and carry savings all month long at Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. And always online at burtonpools.com. Burton Pools and Spas, your source for backyard fun.
Have you recently experienced possible hail damage to your roof? Is it just time to replace the one you currently have? Brothers Roofing and Restoration is a properly licensed and insured local roofing contractor in Arkansas. Brother Alexander has over 25 years of experience in home insurance and adjusting and residential roofing. Brothers Roofing Crew has 17 years of experience themselves. He provides free estimates with the most competitive pricing in the area while using the industry's best materials. So call 479-353-3877 to arrange a time for Brother to inspect your roof.
Wheels RV in Springdale wants you to seek out all the natural state has to offer this year. Explore Arkansas in a new RV from Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, or Alliance. All the best brands at the best prices. Enjoy peace of mind with our lifetime warranty on every new RV and a mobile service shuttle to keep you camping. So come on in and discover why Wheels RV was voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. 5 miles west of I-49, exit 72. Seek, explore, discover with Wheels RV.
Hi folks, Larry Rath here for Rath Auto Resources, where it's trading time. I really need to keep my lot stocked, so all this month, I'm giving up to $3,100 extra for your trade. Even if you still owe money on your car, up to $3,100 extra goes a long way to help you get into a nicer, newer car today. Call, go online, or come by and choose from a great selection of Rath Road Ready cars, trucks, and SUVs. Each one hand-picked and inspected in our Meineke Car Care Center. Plus, our For the People credit approval process works with the country's best banks and lenders to make sure you drive off with a payment you can afford. If you're keeping the car you have, let us take care of it for you in our Meineke Car Care Center with free AC performance checks, half-off brakes, and buy three, get one free on all tires. Better yet, trade it in for something nicer and newer today and get up to $3,100 extra on trade during trading time at Arkansas's favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources, and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online, rathauto.com.
Requires bank approval. Negative equity may be refinanced. Offer absolutely ends by May 31st, 2021.
They say, trust the process. But if enjoyment isn't part of that process, don't trust the process. Michelob Ultra, superior light beer. Enjoy responsibly. AB Michelob Ultra Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
New Bud Light Seltzer?
Yep.
A hard seltzer with a hint of fruit flavor?
Yep.
Can I try one?
Yep.
That tastes great.
Told ya.
Bud Light Seltzer, unquestionably good. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Seltzer. IRC Beers, beer in Texas, St. Louis, Missouri.
Have you ever been to River City Bistro for a brunch on the weekends? Every Saturday and Sunday. River City is open at 10 a.m. with a special brunch menu. Eggs and omelets any way you like. Premium bacon, sausage and ham, waffles, eggs benedict, and a great drink menu featuring mimosas, Bloody Marys, and all your brunch favorites. We will see you for brunch every Saturday and Sunday starting at 10 a.m. at River City Bistro, 7320 Rogers Avenue in the Stonewood Village Shopping Center.
Building a home can be stressful. This is true whether you're the homeowner or the contractor. Many times these issues result in a lawsuit. If you are a homeowner or a contractor and find yourself needing legal help, call the attorneys at Kevin Hickey Law Partner. With experience representing homeowners as well as non-payment or other issues that could arise during construction, contact Brad Hull or Kevin Hickey at 479-434-2414 in the River Valley or 479-802-6560 in Northwest Arkansas, or check them out on the web at artriallawyers.com.
Hey, grounds guys.
Hey, what?
I've got one guy that mows my yard, another guy that sprays for weeds, another group that does my landscaping, and I'm probably forgetting someone that does something else. Wouldn't it be easier to just call one place for all my yard work?
You betcha. When it comes to yard work, just call the grounds guys. Mowing, maintenance, weed control, landscaping, we do it all. Call 479-303-GUYS. That's 303-G-U-Y-S. Or visit groundsguys.com in Northwest Arkansas in the Fort Smith area. The grounds guys. Leave the yard work to us.
Spring has sprung and the summer heat will be here soon.
Now is a great time to upgrade your air conditioning system. From now until the end of May, Carrier's Cool Cash rebates will save you up to $1,500 on a new heating and cooling system. Schedule your free estimate today at AtchleyAir.com.
When your air conditioner breaks, you know who to call. There's only one choice. AtchleyAir.com.
Could you see yourself as a barbecue pitmaster? Bloomberg Smokehouse is hiring pitmasters, meat cutters, prep cooks, cashiers, and dishwashers. Stop by Monday through Friday from 8:30 to 4:30 at 8000 Phoenix Avenue in Fort Smith. Bloomberg Smokehouse is opening May the 10th, and training starts May the 4th. Bloomberg Smokehouse is locally owned and operated. For questions, call them at 479-551-2999 or email them at blueember01@gmail.com. Blue Ember Smokehouse, fresh, prime, smoked.
ESPN 95.3.
Good morning to the Morning Rush, everybody.
Here's his pitch. Wallace hits a high fly ball to left field, carrying back. Graham's tiptoeing to the wall, and Graham reaches up. It's gone. It is another home run.
Streaming live at hitthatline.com.
It's cool to see Christian Franklin not just get co-SEC Player of the Week, but SEC Player of the Week. We'll get into that and some other headlines coming up here on the Morning Rush. Also, want to dive into kind of stemming off the Razorback Roadshow coming up. You got tickets. You got an opportunity to just see one Razorback sporting event this next season. Are you paying for football tickets? Are you paying for basketball tickets? Are you paying for baseball tickets? That's next on the Morning Rush.
Have you had a fence blown down last night, damaged by storms? Call the fence man, 782-3936. I know, you know, these straight line winds that we saw last night can certainly cause a lot of harm to fencing. And the fence man's there for fencing repairs or fencing replacements. So if you need a new fence as a result of the storms last night, you got 4, 5, 10 sections, whatever, blown down. Hey, the fence man's there for you, 782-3936. That's 782-3936. They repair, they build all kinds of fencing. They do automatic gates. Anything involving a fence, the fence man does it. 479-782-3936 for the fence man. He ain't afraid of no work.
It's also National Concert Day. That's our Morning Rush poll question, your favorite concert. We'll get into that conversation in hour number three. But first, give credit to where credit is due. Christian Franklin had himself a series down in Alex Box Stadium. I want to say he went 6-for-11. Down there, he wins SEC Player of the Week. Good to see him respond and just have a really solid series. And guys, the baseball team, Clay, we haven't really touched on this yet with you. Baseball team, first time since 2004, first time ever outside of that win, series win in 2004. They get it done in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Tom, we kind of talked about this with Tom yesterday, not necessarily a monkey off their back, but a win you needed against a program that you've had trouble against in recent years.
Yeah, they just keep on rolling, and they did to LSU just like what they did done to everybody else. You know, they've gone on the road and performed wonderfully, and they, you know, they take on the personality of their coach, just solid as a rock, and they're really talented. You have to remember that they've got four position players that were preseason all first team all SEC, and that I don't think that's ever happened. So that gives you an idea of the quality on this team. Mm-hmm. And they hit the ball so hard in the Sunday game, especially in the ninth inning. And you know, I think LSU's fortunate to win one game because Arkansas was in the process of making one of those patented comebacks. Mm-hmm. And the line drive that Casey Opitz hit, the third baseman caught it out of self-defense. I mean, it was going to go all the way through his chest if he didn't put his glove up.
Yeah. 15 wins right now in SEC play. Anytime you get 20, you feel like you've had not just a great year, but yep, an elite year. They're on pace basically with what they've been doing, winning 2 out of 3 with the 3 series left to get to 21. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know how you equate that in other sports. That would be an 11 win regular season in football, perhaps. You know, in basketball, that would probably be winning 25 in the regular season. To do that in the SEC, it's still a sport. It's all about the postseason. But Clay, this team, while they're not sweeping a lot of opponents, only one SEC sweep, just consistent. Hadn't lost an SEC series either with three to go with Georgia, a tough road series with Tennessee, then Florida at home. If they can keep up this two out of three, they're going to top 20 wins, which I don't know unless you pay a lot of attention and followed it for years. Give our audience a sense of what an accomplishment that is to win 20 SEC games, possibly one more than that if they kept their current pace on track.
Yeah, when you win 18 or 19, you're usually going to win your division. But if you win 20-plus, you're probably got a chance to be overall champion. And they've got a chance to win not just the division but the league. And just to put it in perspective, college baseball analysts say this was the toughest year in the SEC, the most talent, the deepest rosters, and they're just rolling. And they pound people. They've got one little weakness. They've got to find one more starting pitcher, and I think it's important to do that. You know, they can win the league without that Sunday starter, but when they get into postseason, you get to those Sunday-Monday games in a regional or the third and deciding game in a super regional, if, you know, somebody forces you there, you've got to have another starting pitcher. And so that's, you know, it might be Zebulon Vermillion might roll into that. He's pitched a little better this weekend. So I think it's important for them to find that. And they have not had midweek games where they could, you know, get some extra innings for some of these guys that they think might be. So that's the tough part, and that's the kind of missing link to keep them from really being a team that you would say is the favorite in Omaha.
Yeah, in preseason you thought Connor Nolan would be in that mix or in this conversation as one of your mainstays, or Vermillion, and, you know, Connor comes back and has a rough recovery outing here and a bad inning. Couldn't get through the inning and gave up six runs. And, I mean, that's about as tough and rough a pitching performance, Clay, as I've seen from an Arkansas pitcher in a while.
Yep, he didn't have any velocity, didn't have any location, and his breaking ball wasn't sharp. That adds up to getting hit hard.
That's exactly what happened.
Yeah,
keeping it going with the headlines this morning. So Missouri former defensive end Trey Williams has decided to commit to Arkansas as a grad transfer, a former player of Barry Odom, so another connection for Barry Odom. Another hire that's been made for the Arkansas men's basketball team, Gus Arginal, who has been on Eric Musselman's staff before. He's got 17 years of college experience. Coach Arginal is going to join us tomorrow, I think, at 8 o'clock. He was at Cal State Fullerton, also was at Nevada, as I mentioned, and now he's going to be the newest assistant on Muss's staff. Clay, any thoughts on the newest Arkansas basketball hire?
Yeah, it makes sense, and they should continue to roll. He knows exactly what the expectations are of the head coach, and he and those are really high expectations. He puts a lot on his assistant coaches. They have a well-oiled machine in how they delegate, how he holds them accountable, and I think he'll fit in just perfectly, as you know.
He knows what he's getting into.
No doubt about that. I mean, Eric Musselman, when you see him from the outside looking in, a lot of us, you know, we see the social media stuff and the interviews, and he seems like he's a lot of fun all the time. But he works, and he expects his guys to work long hours. And it doesn't happen just because of fun.
Yeah.
It's hard work.
Last headline for you this morning. So Amazon Prime Video is going to get Thursday Night Football starting in 2022. It's no longer going to be on the NFL Network or Fox. Something to just keep an eye on that you may want to pay attention to, and just how technology and sports are going to continue to move in these odd entities directions. Yep. And not necessarily odd, but not traditional forms.
As long as we continue to expand high-speed internet into rural areas and into inner cities and other places, it'll work just fine. But you got to have good internet in order to make this stuff work. All right, does it look like a tree bomb went off in your yard this morning? Yard a mess? Call the grounds guys. They serve Northwest Arkansas and the River Valley. The do-it-all guys, mowing, landscaping, cleanup. You might need that today, plus weed and feed, continued maintenance to make your yard look great year-round. Right now, if you call, you'll get half off your first six-step weed and feed application. If you need some help with the yard this morning, call the grounds guys, 479-303-GUYS. That's 303 guys, or log on at groundsguys.com.
What tickets are you buying this upcoming season? That's next, hour three.
Hi, it's Jan from Toyota. Summer's finally here, and with a great deal on a new Camry, RAV4, Highlander.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab. C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappie.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, succulent, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
This song might make you feel cool, but it perfectly describes a fool. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road and gonna ride till I can't no more, and can't nobody tell me nothing. This path will only lead you to God's wrath, because the Bible says the wicked refuse discipline and treat his words like trash. What good is a nice beat when you're headed down the wrong street? I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Think about it.
West Arkansas area. If you have a CDL license without an automatic restriction and want to be home every night, want to work with a company that offers great pay, benefits, and a great team environment with growth opportunity, apply today at jobs.crh.com. Again, that's jobs.crh.com. Standard Materials Group is an equal opportunity employer.
Was your roof damaged by recent storms? Don't fall victim to out-of-town contractors and fly-by-night repairmen. Trust the local roofing professionals at Able Roofing. Call their local number, 474-0006, for a free roof inspection. Never trust something as important as the roofing system on your home to a storm chaser. Able Roofing, 474-0006, will work with your insurance company. Call now for your free roof inspection, 474-0006. Able Roofing, the hometown roofers.
Owning an LS tractor is about a lot of things.
For me, it's about lift capacity.
It's about the hydraulics.
Owning an LS, it's about how well it's made.
Steel, baby.
More features.
Standard features.
It's about the land.
Having something passed down.
It's about having pride in my work.
It's about owning the best.
LS Tractor. What's it about for you?
Discover what LS Tractors are all about at R-Track, Arkansas's oldest LS Tractor dealer, on I-40, exit 58, Clarksville, or visit rtrackwithac.com.
Peachtree Hospice is now Heart of Hospice. We're still the same compassionate team you've come to know and trust. As Heart of Hospice, it's our goal to transform end-of-life care for patients and families in Western Arkansas and Eastern Oklahoma by providing physical, emotional, and spiritual support tailored to the patient's needs and wishes. Peachtree Hospice is now Heart of Hospice, still providing compassionate care when it's needed the most. Call us today at 844-464-0411.
Getting the kids to practice on time. Remembering if it's your day to bring snacks. Making it to the game with a clean jersey. Why are simple things sometimes so complicated? Thankfully, with Auto Owners, insurance doesn't have to be one of them. Auto Owners works with independent agents who answer when you call, so you can worry about more important things, like whether your kid is going to run toward first or third base. That's simple human sense.
Call Kohler & Green Insurance today in Fort Smith at 484-9888 and Kohler & Green Insurance in Van Buren at 474-9888.
Evans Body Shop is ready to work for you. Bring us your cars, your trucks, your SUVs, and we will get them back to like new condition just in time for all of the good times that come with spring and summer. No time to come by for an estimate? Visit our website and utilize our mobile estimating tool. We will keep you updated and informed throughout the repair process, and you can pick up your freshly repaired and detailed vehicle with the peace of mind that our lifetime paint warranty provides. Come by and see us today at 412 Gordon Avenue, Van Buren.
Evans Body Shop, where we meet the nicest people by accident.
Have you been looking for your next place to call home and just haven't found the right one? Then it's time to check out the properties at Trinity Multifamily. With a variety of apartments, duplexes, townhomes, and houses, there is surely one to fit your needs. Whether it's in the River Valley, Northwest Arkansas, or Central Arkansas that you are looking at, they have you covered. Give them a call today. Trinity Multifamily, 479-452-1817. That's 479-452-1817. Or online at trinitymultifamily.com to search rental properties near you.
Have you recently experienced possible hail damage to your roof? Is it just time to replace the one you currently have? Brothers Roofing and Restoration is a properly licensed and insured local roofing contractor in Arkansas. Brother Alexander has over 25 years of experience in home insurance and adjusting and residential roofing. Brothers Roofing Crew has 17 years of experience themselves. He provides free estimates with the most competitive pricing in the area while using the industry's best materials. So call 479-353-3877 to arrange a time for Brother to inspect your roof.
ESPN Arkansas weather.
For today, cold front will march on through. Chance of showers and thunderstorms with that front. Also, some cooler air will be galloping on in. We're going to see temperatures across the north falling into the upper 50s, falling into the upper 60s across the south. A colder night, overnight lows in the 40s. I'm Sally Russell with your forecast on ESPN Arkansas.
Listen to Halftime with Phil Elson, Maddie T, and SmackDown. Now every weekday from 11 to 1.
You're listening to The Morning Rush, live from the Busch Light Studios on ESPN 95.3, KERX Paris Fort Smith.
This hour of The Morning Rush is brought to you by Bud Light, brewed with the best barley, rice, water, and hops to be America's favorite light beer. Bud Light, please drink responsibly.
Called strike three, it's over. From one win 5 years ago to number one in the SEC in 2021, the Razorbacks have their first SEC championship.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios.
You are causing a major disturbance on my time.
If I'm here and you're here, doesn't that make it our time?
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station. Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
There's a lot of Lions, Tigers, and Bears, but they ain't but one Razorback. Number one.
This is The Morning Rush.
Borderline erotic.
With Ty Richardson.
Hi, Ty.
That's cool. I can dig it.
And Tommy Kraft.
Do I look happy?
What's wrong?
Lloyd!
The Morning Rush starts right now.
It's a Toyota Tuesday, and we're getting into hour number three of The Morning Rush alongside Tommy Kraft and Clay Henry, the publisher of Hogs Illustrated. I'm Ty Richardson. Still a lot to get to this hour. If you could only buy tickets to Razorback football, basketball, baseball this next upcoming season, this next calendar year, what would you do? The Arkansas softball team, as you heard at the top of our open, clinched its first share of the SEC regular season title in the history of the program, and we've yet to dive into our favorite concerts on National Concert Day. We've got a lot of text in, a lot of replies on our Morning Rush poll question, and we'll get to that coming up later in the segment.
Hey, now's the time to buy and start building the backyard of your dreams at Burton Pools and Spas. All month long, cash and carry savings on above-ground pools starting at $19.99, semi-in-ground pools for less than $10,000, and big savings on chemical packages to help get your pool ready for spring and summer right now at Burton Pools and Spas. Cash and carry savings right now this month at Burton Pools and Spas, Springdale and in Fort Smith. Look online at burtonpools.com. Burton Pools and Spas is your source for backyard fun.
So, y'all, you got this one Razorback road show. It's going to start May the 17th. Dumas, Hot Springs, Harrison, Little Rock, Jasper, Russellville, Pine Bluff, Morrilton, Conway are some of the places that they're kind of making their pit stops at. And Tommy, the reason they do this, try and generate excitement, generate funds to the Razorback Foundation, season tickets, not just for football, but other parts as well. Let's say money is very much a part of this whole thing in the sense of, hey, you only have enough money to buy either football season tickets, basketball season tickets, or baseball season tickets this next year. Where are you going? Are you going with the baseball team that's the model of consistency, the number one unanimous team in the country this year, that's going to have a lot of pieces back next year? Are you going to go with the basketball team in Muss's third year that he had the best team they've had in 25-plus years? Mm-hmm. Are you going to go football just because it's football? And hoping that Sam Pittman, with this schedule, with Texas at home, with some great teams ahead, which one are you going if you could only choose one sport this next year?
I think for me in this next year, in this current environment, if it's a one-year deal, I'm probably going basketball this next year. I am anticipating what Eric Musselman can do. He's you know, we've seen his ability to revamp rosters year to year, revamp his coaching staff when needed, make that change or two. And you know, we talked about that in the last segment, the latest addition. I want to see if this program can take that step forward, because I think they're the next program that's, you know, close to taking that elite step, and the Final Four would be that. Now, you know, a couple steps from a national title, but you can get to that point, things fall your way, who knows what might happen. But I'm most interested and most excited about what might be ahead for this basketball program.
I think it's hard to differ. What about you, Clay?
Well, I think Tommy makes an interesting point, and I expect that Bud Walton will be close to a sellout, and it'll be rocking. I think the atmosphere is probably, you know, going to be more electric than what we've seen in a long time. And football is unique in that it's, you know, such a big, you know, atmosphere, and I think it has a chance to be really good. But I have to admit that if you could give me a seat right next to Bobby Smittle, I'd probably go for baseball. That's hog noxious, yeah, if anybody doesn't know.
Right, and be, you know, right there behind the dugout.
Because that's a show.
I know that if I have season tickets to Bud Walton Arena, that 4 or 5 times a year, at least on Saturdays, and probably a few more times if Kentucky's coming midweek, or a huge conference game, if, you know, like the Alabama game, or a team that maybe you're not thinking about this year that rises up in the rankings and it becomes a huge conference game, I know that the atmosphere and the electric environment you're going to be in at Bud Walton Arena is second to none. Mm-hmm. Yes, Baum Walker can be great. I don't think football is going to be close to that this year. There may be some excitement for the Texas game, but it can't be sustained. I'm telling you, when Bud Walton's at his best, there's nothing better on that campus. And if you're an adrenaline junkie, you're an atmosphere junkie, you're an environment junkie, you can't beat Bud Walton when it's full.
Mm-hmm. Here's what I look at. Which sport of the three has had the least amount of success in the last 20-some-odd years? It's basketball. And it's an easy answer. It's not even close.
Over 20 years.
Now, 10, you can make the argument, yeah, football.
Right.
But when I shifted to 20, mm-hmm, since it's been – we had the drought of the Sweet 16 for Arkansas since 96.
Well, 20 takes you all the way back, and you cover the McFadden years. So, mm-hmm, 06 and
Tyler,
07.
Tyler and Ryan.
All of that.
That's,
yeah,
what I'm saying. Like, right, it's not even a comparison close when you have that debate. That, mm-hmm, was the drought of the three major. Now, it feels like it's been an eternity for Arkansas football, but, y'all, it's only been 11 years or 10 years since you were at the height of the SEC, essentially. So, baseball is the model of consistency. If I miss all of next year's games, I'm not too worried about it, because I think the following year they're probably still going to be good. Maybe that's an egregious take. I don't think it is, based on what Dave Van Horn's done over the years. Football, like you said, as Clay, and like you mentioned as well, as much you're excited about the Texas game and stuff, there's just something about what you felt inside of Bud Walton Arena this past year, what you watch, if you didn't get a chance to go to the game, what you watched on TV during that 12-game SEC winning streak, that I had some older listeners of the Morning Rush telling me it feels like the 90s. We had callers, texters on a weekly basis tell us, man, it feels like the golden days. And that's what you want to get back to, and that's what you think you're going to get back to. I can't think of the last time I've seen this team ranked outside the preseason top 15. This year, like, if you go through the Gary Parrishes, the Jeff Borzillos, all these different college basketball writers, the Jeff Goodmans, Goodman had you all the way in like the top 7, I think. Like, everyone that I've looked on like rankings next year thinks you're going to be good. You start inside the top 10 for Arkansas basketball and you stay in that realm the majority of the season, you better give up another mortgage on your house to get those season tickets, because it's going to be worth every stinking penny.
We have to understand, though, Kentucky's not going to be down 2 years in a row. Duke's not going to be out of it 2 years in a row. North Carolina, all these blue blood programs that took a year off for whatever reason. Kansas took the first half of the year off, then kind of made a resurgence in the second half. Clay, you know, college basketball, the teams that had the rise this year, they're going to do it again next year. And Arkansas being one of them, you know, they're going to have to do it probably contending with at least half or more of those blue bloods back in the mix next year.
Yeah, I think Texas Tech will take a dip. I think I expect North Carolina to take a dip. I may be totally wrong, but I think Hubert Davis is going to find that being a head coach is more challenging than I mean, it is not easy to take over a program like North Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
And so I don't know about them as far as, you know, how they're going to go. But, yeah, I think it's the excitement with the fan base is just intense right now. You know, it's, you know, the conversations that you have on Razorback Sports are always now a little bit of basketball, even though basketball is not being played right now. If you go around the state and you say, what do you think about basketball? I mean, they start talking about Eric Musselman in – you know, some of the old basketball folks that just been kind of laying in the weeds are now coming out that they like what they see, and it's fundamentals, and it's an NBA style, and you know the adjustments that you see made during a game are incredibly fast, and you know if something's not going right, he fixes it. And it may not be something that they've worked on. You know, he's got the courage to change what he's doing and do it quickly.
Let's end on this point. Clay, one of the things you were telling me last week before I made my way down to Baton Rouge is it's not going to be the same because LSU's not good in baseball. And you're exactly right. Beating Texas as fun as it was in 2014 in the Texas Bowl, it's not the same as when you beat them in 1981, and I think they were the number one team in the country, if I remember that right. It's not the same when you beat them in 64. And so,
well, it ain't the same as in the Cotton Bowl in January 1, 2000.
And to your point about Kentucky coming back, Tommy, you want Kentucky to be back because you want when they step into Bud Walton Arena next year, you want when Cal walks out and Dave Van Horn's waving him goodbye, you don't want it to be because he's ejected. You want it to be because he's ticked off because his team just lost and they have a good basketball team. As fun as it was going on the road to Lexington to beat Kentucky this year, it doesn't feel the same when they're not the Kentucky of years past. That would be something that you want. And listen, that Kentucky-Arkansas matchup, you better get your tickets now, because it's not going to be an easy ticket to find come whenever that game rolls around.
I don't know when they go on sale, but you're right. You better be in line early. Hey, if you're building a home, it's a stressful time, whether you're the homeowner or the contractor, no matter which side of the equation you're on. Stressful things can happen, whether it's contractors not showing up, subs not showing up, non-payment. All of these things can result in lawsuits. So if you're the homeowner or the contractor and you find yourself needing legal help, call the attorneys at the Kevin Hickey Law Partners. They have experience representing homeowners and contractors. Brad Hall or Kevin Hickey are ready to walk you through what the next step is. 479-434-2414. That's the River Valley office. 479-802-6560 in Northwest Arkansas. Those phone numbers and more details about Kevin and his team are online at artriallawyers.com. That's artriallawyers.com.
So it's National Concert Day, everyone, ladies and gentlemen. And it's been a while since I've been to a concert, especially with COVID and everything going on. Not just that, but prior to that. And I know everyone has their favorite concert, favorite memory from that said concert. And there's a bunch of good ones. You listen to Chicken Fried Instrumental, Zach Brown Band. There's the country fans, the rock fans, whatever fans. But that is our Morning Rush poll question on National Concert Day. What's the best concert you've ever been to? Hayden in Bentonville texted in this morning. He says one of his favorite concerts, guys, was at JJ's after the Hogs beat Portland State. Justin Moore played, John Daly and Bobby Bones sang, Hunter Yurcheck was there. It was a Razorback party. If you guys ever, I haven't personally been to a Justin Moore concert.
I have not.
Have you guys been?
No. Nope.
Love his music, but I have not been to a concert of his yet.
Nope. Have not. You know, like I said, I've seen.
I have.
you have? How was it?
It was pretty good. Bo Mattingly and I both went to a Justin Moore concert at the River Amphitheater, whatever you want to call it, in Little Rock Marketplace. Mm-hmm. And he was in rare form. I mean, he is a performer. I mean, he's not, you know, he can sing in church. I mean, he literally can. He's got that kind of voice, but he will rock it out.
Love that. All right, so text in here this morning, this tweet, Metallica on the Death Magnetic Tour in 2009 in the Mandalay Bay Event Center in Las Vegas with Machine Head and Volbeat opening. Any inclination to go to that concert back in the day?
Probably not even back in the day.
Nope. Clay?
That would be the last place on earth I would want to be. I would rather be assigned to cover Texas football for a year than to watch.
Than go to that.
For 2 hours of that. Yeah. I mean, you'd lose your ears, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it would be the end of being able to hear.
So let's think about where y'all would want to be. That's a place you don't want to be. Mm-hmm. Where is the concert you'd like to go back to and relive again?
Well, I had two on the books last year that, I don't think there was any concerts hardly anywhere last year. But you got Zac Brown playing. One of the best shows I've been to. I saw Zac Brown in Memphis.
He sounds exactly like they do on the CD. It's the craziest thing I've ever seen.
That's where you know the good ones are. There's some artists that could get in the studio and, you know, get processed up and get edited, and it all sounds great on an album. But, the ones that can do it live, now those are the real talents. And Zac Brown and they play a variety of stuff. It wasn't just their stuff. They, they played covers for a lot of different genres and a lot of different stuff. So that was a great show, a lot of lights, and, you know, they entertained you for, it was over 3 hours of entertainment. So that was a lot of fun. I've been to probably 12 James Taylor concerts, going to another one in August. Love seeing James. He's probably down to his last year or two of touring. I don't know. He's in his early 70s. He's about Clay's age. He's 72 or 3. So he won't be.
I'm almost done touring, too.
And then the other one, the Troubadour, one of my all-time favorites. Saw him in Tulsa last, George Strait. And he just, you know how good he is. He just goes to one corner of the stage and plays his guitar and sings. And then he'll walk and play two or three songs there and walk to the other corner and play. He doesn't need all the laser light shows and all this stuff and run around. And he just stands there with the guitar and sings, got the band in the middle. Just walks in a circle kind of on that square stage and just plays music.
And in between songs, he goes, thank you. Yeah. Thank you very much.
You brought up Zac Brown Band, Tommy. To this day, that's the best.
That's a great show.
The most sounding like they do on iTunes or whatever you listen to, Spotify. Jimbo and Hackett texting Tommy. He says when he saw him at Mulberry Mountain in the freezing rain, they bought the whole crowd of legal age around a land shark. So
there you go.
Be something that
like him even more now.
Yeah. How do you go about that? It's like, hey, are you 21?
Yes.
Get him a land shark. Are you 21? Are you not 21? Oh, get him a land shark anyway.
You ever tried a land shark beer, Clay?
I'm not sure I know what that is.
It's Jimmy Buffett's beer. I first had one on my way to the Citrus Bowl in 06, I guess that was.
Were you covering the game?
Yeah, covering the game. We stopped in Gulf Shores to spend the night, went to Lulu's, his sister's restaurant there. I don't think it's there anymore. And they had this new beer called Land Shark. And it's made by Anheuser-Busch now, but that's Jimmy Buffett's beer.
So weren't you just chastised? Wasn't that a work trip?
It was a work trip. I drove from here to Orlando.
So weren't you just chastising me for drinking on a supposed work trip?
I was on the work trip having dinner, driving to Orlando. We'd stopped for the night.
But you had alcohol.
There is a big difference between what he did and what you did.
I had a beer. You brought a receipt in.
You brought a $300.
You brought a $325 bar tab in yesterday with about 51 lemon drop shots on it and wanted to expense that.
Was there any lemon drop shots for you?
None.
We
had a couple of Land Shark beers.
I haven't had a Land Shark in a while.
If I had a receipt like that, I wouldn't show it to anybody.
No. Oh, he was proud of it,
I know. It tells you a whole lot.
Yeah.
Yep. So my favorite concert, my buddy Jim Daniel, who, by the way, bless his heart, he's in Russellville today burying his 99-year-old mom.
Oh, geez.
And, just had a great life. Oh. So, they're celebrating, 99 years.
Wow.
But So Jim's a Colorado guy and a real-life cowboy, has a ranch, cows and horses, and he's taking me riding up into the High Lakes in Colorado. The first two or three times out there, everything was just kind of mundane, you know, ride horses, catch fish. And the third time, he says, I got need 2 days at the end of the trip. I got something set up. And he's a real low-key, doesn't really pump anything up. And so the next thing I knew, we were headed to Cheyenne, went to the Frontier Days Rodeo and watched the rodeo. He had seats above the buck and shoot, which the Frontier is the big daddy of them all. And then that night, you know, they pulled a stage out in the middle of the arena and they had George Strait play in front of 24,000 cowboys. And we were there on the front row. We were on the rail right in front of the stage, and it was just awesome.
Can't you see Clay with his leather chaps on and his cowboy hat?
I had my George Strait Resistol on, had it pulled down tight. And I did not have a rodeo belt buckle, but, man, I bought one before it was all over. You know, it says Cheyenne on it. But, yeah, when he sang Cheyenne in Cheyenne, and, the whole place, you know, all the cowboys just threw their caps straight up.
Like I graduation. Caps,
their hats. Yeah, just threw them straight up, and then they passed them around. Everybody got the right hat after it was over. And, it was pretty sweet. You know, it would be.
I don't know how you sang, top that.
He sang 38 songs in 2.5 hours, and 36 of them were number one hits. You know, one of them that wasn't a number one hit is Amarillo, which you would think it was number one, but it wasn't. So,
man,
hard to top that, boys.
That's pretty good right there.
Still got a bunch of texts that we'll get to later on in the program. Mine has to be Jimmy Buffett in Dallas, Texas. That's where it is. So I don't think he's going to do it this year. But he's only got a few more concerts. You brought up. Who'd you bring up earlier? That only's got a
JT.
JT, yeah. Jimmy's only got a few more concerts in him. Yeah. He hadn't been to a
I'm sorry, Ty. I thought you were done. But I was going to say my buddy Bill Pettit went to a concert, I think in Texas Stadium.
Mm-hmm.
And it was Jimmy Buffett, George Strait, Alan Jackson.
Wow.
How would you top that?
That's unbeatable.
Pretty good. Stapleton's the next one I want to see. I haven't seen Stapleton in person. I got to see Chris Stapleton soon. Hey, if you're waking up to some roof damage this morning, or you're not sure, you had some straight line winds, maybe some hail that came through last night, call Brothers Roofing, 479-353-3877. Brother Alexander's properly licensed in Arkansas and more than adequately insured to take care of everything that you need. They've got crews that can come out and take care of your home. So if you need a roof inspection and to make sure that you're dealing with a company that's got the experience, that's Brothers Roofing. 25 years of experience from both sides of the process, which means Brother can confidently work with your insurance adjuster and make sure that everything is right for you and you get the most for your money on a new roof. They do shingles, underlayment, ice and water barriers, a whole lot more. So if you're just starting the process, call Brothers Roofing, 353-3877.
All right, coming up in the program, let's talk about this Arkansas softball team that shared the regular SEC title as of last night.
This is Toyota Tuesday on the Morning Rush. Get by your local Toyota dealer for a test drive today. Toyota, let's go places.
Wheels RV in Springdale wants you to seek out all the natural state has to offer this year. Explore Arkansas in a new RV from Grand Design, Forest River, KZ, Heartland, Keystone, or Alliance. All the best brands at the best prices. Enjoy peace of mind with our lifetime warranty on every new RV and a mobile service shuttle to keep you camping. So come on in and discover why Wheels RV was voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. 5 miles west of I-49, exit 72. Seek, explore, discover with Wheels RV.
Hi, I'm Bill Bolton of NWA Gold, Silver, and Coins. I started in this business in 1972 at an auction house that specialized in antique and estate jewelry, sterling silver, and coins. In that time, I've seen gold go from $35 an ounce to today's price of $1,683. I want to talk to you about the coins you may have inherited and how important it is to deal with someone who understands coins and this market. In 2011, we had a mother and daughter come into our store and sell us a lot of jewelry they no longer wore for $3,300. The daughter then pulled out an 1850 California $10 gold piece. Jeremy offered her $900, and she accepted his offer. He then advised her to have this coin graded. She did, and she sold it for $36,000. If you don't know what you have, please come see Jeremy in our Bentonville store. Don't sell it in an auction or an estate sale and get less money. What's in your safety deposit box could be worth thousands. NWA Gold, Silver, and Coins, Bentonville, Fayetteville.
Have you recently experienced possible hail damage to your roof? Is it just time to replace the one you currently have? Brothers Roofing and Restoration is a properly licensed and insured local roofing contractor in Arkansas. Brother Alexander has over 25 years of experience in home insurance and adjusting and residential roofing. Brothers Roofing Crew has 17 years of experience themselves. He provides free estimates with the most competitive pricing in the area while using the industry's best materials. So call 479-353-3877 to arrange a time for Brother to inspect your roof.
For a dependable, fuel-efficient tractor from a company committed to the future, choose a Branson tractor. Each of our tractors is backed by a 6-year limited warranty with models available ranging in horsepower from 22 to 58. You are sure to find the tractor that is right for you. Make sure you call or stop in today at the new location for Bush Tractor at 6100 South Zero Street in Fort Smith. Again, that is 6100 South Zero Street in Fort Smith. Or you can check them out online at bushtractor.com.
Ramos Roofing is a local roofing company and have over 25 years of experience in the Oklahoma area. Are you looking for a residential or commercial roofing need? Ramos Roofing is the business you can trust. Offering discounts for senior citizens, law enforcement, and healthcare workers, Ramos Roofing can help you with your insurance claim. Ramos Roofing, working with you to build a better home. Call 479-420-9903. That's 479-420-9903 for Ramos Roofing.
Locally owned Lumber One can handle all of your building needs. They've built their business on having great relationships with everybody from contractors and builders to the everyday build-it-yourself. Lumber One is a full-line door shop to handle all of your door, window, and trim needs. And along with lumber, roofing and drywall products, attic wall and floor insulation is available. Lumber One also does blueprint takeoff with access to design services with estimates available. So go where the pros go. Lumber One, located on Industrial Park Road in Van Buren.
Franco Furniture is your Made in the USA headquarters. We carry as many Made in the USA products as we can, including Jackson and Catnapper sofas and loves, Speed Queen washers and dryers, and Serenity mattresses. This month, we are offering special pricing on cash and finance. We are family-owned, offer in-store no-credit check financing, and service after the sale. Deals on cash and credit. In-store no-credit check financing is available. Frank Roll Furniture, 405 Fort Street, Barling, Arkansas. Best seats in the house.
Building a home can be stressful. This is true whether you're the homeowner or the contractor. Many times these issues result in a lawsuit. If you are a homeowner or a contractor and find yourself needing legal help, call the attorneys at Kevin Hickey Law Partner. With experience representing homeowners as well as non-payment or other issues that could arise during construction, contact Brad Hull or Kevin Hickey at 479-434-2414 in the River Valley or 479-802-6560 in Northwest Arkansas. Or check them out on the web at artriallawyers.com.
Largemouth bass will be spawning soon at ponds and lakes all over Arkansas and Oklahoma. One of the best lures to catch them on at this time is the famous Young Dinger. We make them by the truckloads in Fort Smith in 3, 4, 5, and 6 inch sizes, and they are in tackle boxes of bass anglers all over the U.S. and all over the world. Wacky Rigging, the 5-inch model, can't be beat for spawning bass. Available at Walmart, Bass Pro Shops, Academy, LureNet.com, and tackle stores all over the place, the Young Dinger.
Farm Credit has been a trusted friend for over 100 years. They are ag financing experts. So whether you're a longtime farmer, new to farming, or buying your dream home or land in the country, their experienced staff has a plan to fit your goals, needs, and your bottom line. From farms to land, livestock, equipment, and more, Farm Credit finances it all. Learn more at myaglender.com. Farm Credit is an equal opportunity lender.
ESPN 95.3. The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
Launched by Wallace into left field, back to the wall, and it is into the bullpen. Caden Wallace gives Arkansas the lead with his 7th home run.
Your home for Razorback baseball all season long right here. HitThatLine.com.
Back here on the Morning Rush, the Arkansas softball team finishes with a 40-8 record, including 19-5 in the SEC. They end up getting it done last night, and we'll talk about that, what this means for Courtney Dyfel's squad coming up.
Brought to you by NWA Gold and Silver, Bentonville, Fayetteville, Fort Smith. If you've got gold or silver coins, gold or silver items, you'd like to turn those into cash, find out what they're worth, just take it to NWA Gold and Silver. They buy any gold or silver item, diamond engagement rings, diamond earrings, necklaces, pendants. That's the business they're in. They also sell those items as well. So if you'd like to buy or sell gold or silver items and fine jewelry, they love to welcome you into their stores. They're at 1130 North Walton in Bentonville, Nelson's Crossing by Jason's Deli in Fayetteville, and you'll find them on Rogers Avenue just west of Central Mall in Fort Smith. That's NWA Gold and Silver, Bentonville, Fayetteville, and in Fort Smith.
We'll get to Clay's almost hole-in-one golf story coming up. And do want to give this the softball team some credit. By the way, guys, I had do you guys know what Time Hop is? I know SmackDown does.
Yeah, where it brings up an old picture from a year or three or how many years ago on your social media.
Do you know where I was 2 years ago to the day?
2019. I think probably at a concert or something.
So not at a concert. And, in
Nashville?
In Comic-Con. In a Harley Quinn outfit.
I remember
thanks
that.
To losing my fantasy football league. So 2 years ago today, Clay, I'm going to send you this picture. You're probably going to, I hope this doesn't hurt your heart, but I'm going to send it anyway. 2 years ago today, I had to dress up as Harley Quinn from the Justice League and Suicide Squad. And that was
another something. Reason not to play fantasy football.
Yeah, that's it's rough this morning, but I got that. Graced my time on this morning, but something good.
Oh, wow.
Something good that graced your time on this morning was seeing the Arkansas softball team doing what's never been done in program history, sharing the SEC title. Now, Alabama and Florida have gotten every single one of the SEC title since 2007. You made a point earlier. It's a really good season for Arkansas baseball if you get to 20 wins. Mm-hmm. They get to 19.
20 SEC wins.
Yeah, 20 SEC wins. They get to 19 in the SEC, which is right there. Shows you what Courtney Dyfel's squad was able to accomplish that year. And a lot of Arkansas fans who didn't necessarily watch a lot of softball are pumped about this team.
So Courtney Dyfel in her sixth season, I want to give enough time here in this segment for Clay to give Jeff Long credit for this hire because
smart.
You know, Jeff no longer there, and I know how Clay feels about the former AD at Arkansas. So, Clay, the floor is yours. I just want to make sure you had enough time here before the segment was up to give Jeff Long credit for this quality hire that has led this program to a championship.
Yeah, I would say probably somebody else on his staff found Courtney, and I don't think he spent a lot of time with that, and I sure don't want to give him credit because – no matter how well some of these other sports have done, and Kobe Hale's been great in soccer. There were some good coaches hired on his time, but to flop in a major way with, some of the other hires, especially the way he botched football, you just can't, you can't just pick out one and say, well, yeah, he did great there, because the other just – weighs too much.
Clay just can't give credit where credit's due, can he?
Was the hire for Bielema a flop, or was it the renegotiated contract that was a flop?
Well, he lost, so, I mean, it's a flop however you want to say it. You know, I mean, it's like, and then, you compound that with a poor contract that cost the school so much money. Yeah, I mean, if it had been a good hire, it wouldn't have mattered what the contract was, right?
Okay. No, I think that's a fair point. I was just kind of thinking about that.
But it's a, it's one thing to hire a bad coach. It's another thing to, also give him a bad contract. So it's a double whammy.
And that's what you have to do is, and like what y'all always tell me, and I'd see it firsthand, Jeff Long knew how to schmooze big boys. Clay, you've had to talk with big donors over the years. Obviously, you used to work for Mr. Stevens, and there's certain people that you have to talk to in that facet of life, and then there's others, just the common fan. And if you're in an athletic director position, you can't just be a one-way street. Like, you can't just be the highfalutin, walking around, cocktails, shrimp. Like, you also got to eat
shrimp.
You also no, but I'm saying you also got to eat a bean burrito from Taco Bell every once in a while.
Yeah, like, I mean, it's like, I just can't imagine Jeff Long calling Eddie from Clarksville and like, "How you doing today? Eddie. I mean, that's just not – that wasn't his people. Yeah. So – and that's the whole state of Arkansas. We're not his people. So I mean, Clay, he wasn't around them.
Clay, just to be clear, Clay's given no credit to the success of the softball program to Jeff Long and the hire.
No, I'm giving it to Courtney. I'm giving it to her.
See, you like to, Tommy, you love to pin me down as a country clubbing, Little Rock city slicker, but I'll hang out with anyone. I can. That's important. Like, you can't, and it doesn't matter if you're a sports radio host, your athletic director, if you're a magazine publisher, whatever, you can't just center yourself around just a certain select group of people based on income, based on race, based on religion. You got to be friends with
be diversified. Yeah. Get on all levels. Do all things. Go across all walks.
Yeah.
All that stuff. So anyway, you know what I tried last week for the first time? This Philly beef sandwich at Art's Barbecue.
There you go.
You had one of these?
I had it 3 weeks ago.
Holy
by the way,
smokes.
Wade texted me and said I won the a gun raffle. I'm gonna have a
that's
gun.
That's another story we'll get to.
I'm
in
gonna
a
have
minute.
To have a gun soon. So
hey, the
see how that goes.
The Philly beef sandwich is on the menu for a limited time at Art's Barbecue. They take the smoked ribeye, slice it really thin, and make Philly beef sandwiches out of this. They saute the onions and the bell peppers, then they load it up with plenty of cheese and put it on a hoagie bun, side of your choice. And I'm telling you, it's a two-handed sandwich. There's no doubt about that. And double napkins. If you haven't tried the Philly beef sandwich at Art's, it's on the menu every day. Try them out Tuesday through Saturday. Then on the weekends, the smoked grilled ribeye on Fridays and Saturdays. But you're missing out. You're not doing it right. If you hadn't had the Philly beef sandwich, get by Art's Barbecue on Rogers Avenue today and try the Philly beef sandwich at Art's Barbecue.
Coming up, we'll tell you what's going on in the Bud Light Seltzer Morning Rush podcast and how Clay Henry almost hit a hole-in-one. Man, I need some of that golf help.
This is Toyota Tuesday on the Morning Rush. Get by your local Toyota dealer for a test drive today. Toyota, let's go places.
Cash and carry savings during the month of May at Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. Above ground pools started just $19.99. Check out the semi-in-ground pools starting at $99.97. Plus special savings on chemical packages to get your pool off to the right start this summer. Cash and carry savings all month long at Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. And always online at burtonpools.com. Burton Pools and Spas, your source for backyard fun.
This is Brett Goode, former Razorback and Super Bowl champion with the Green Bay Packers. Everyone loves to be on a winning team. That is why I have joined Henderson Phillips Employer Solutions. Henderson Phillips can help you tackle all your employee benefit, health insurance, and staffing management solutions. Plus, I can help you with any commercial or personal insurance need. Come join my team at Henderson Phillips. Call me, Brett Goode, at 479-651-2292. That's 651-2292.
Standard Materials Group has immediate openings for ready-mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. If you have a CDL license without an automatic restriction and want to be home every night, want to work with a company that offers great pay, benefits, and a great team environment with growth opportunities, apply today at jobs.crh.com. Again, that's jobs.crh.com. Standard Materials Group is an equal opportunity employer.
Picture a can of paint. Now picture a professional painter. Now picture a can of paint from the paint store in Van Buren, perfectly applied by a professional or possibly you. Painting your house could be a pain, and people who think painting as a pain prefer professional paint and pointers from the paint store in Van Buren. The paint store has the best Richards paint and expertly picked colors specifically for you. Need a professional product or a professional? It's the paint store in Van Buren.
I chose Actually Air just because I've always wanted to work for the best. I asked a lot of folks at my church who the best heat and air company is, and 90% of the people I talked to said Ashley was the best. So I wanted to work for the best.
Great things are happening at Ashley Air. We're looking for skilled service and installation technicians for our Fort Smith and Northwest Arkansas locations. We're willing to pay the right person up to $5,000 in hiring bonuses. To apply online, visit our website at ashleyair.com.
ashleyair.com. Hey, Grounds Guys.
Hey, what?
Can you get rid of these weeds in my yard?
You betcha. The Grounds Guys six-step weed and feed service will eliminate those unsightly weeds, keeping your lawn green and pristine all year long. Mention this ad and get your first application for 50% off, and you'll notice the results right away. Call 479-303-GUYS. That's 303-G-U-Y-S. Or go to groundsguys.com for all your lawn care needs in Northwest Arkansas and the Fort Smith area. The Grounds Guys. Leave the yard work to us.
When you've escaped the screens and the sun bathes everything in a golden glow, and your friend hands you a cold organic beer that tastes as perfect as nature itself, that's pure gold. Michelob Ultra Pure Gold, the first national USDA certified organic beer. Organic by nature. Enjoy responsibly. 2020 Anheuser-Busch Michelob Ultra Pure Gold, St. Louis, Missouri.
In the mood for a top shelf night? 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge has your number. Sit back, relax, and enjoy select wines, top shelf spirits, and handcrafted cocktails in a rich, comfortable, sanitized setting with state-of-the-art air filtration. Indulge in one of their delicious appetizers, sandwiches, salads, or specialty items for carryout or dine-in. Open Tuesday through Saturday. Stop by 906 Garrison Avenue in Fort Smith. 906 Garrison in Fort Smith. 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge, defining nightlife in downtown Fort Smith.
When was the last time you looked forward to seeing the dentist? Well, if it's been a while or you haven't had the best of experience with dentistry, meet Marcy Van Ash McKinney of Family Dentistry. They take care of it all. Crowns, bonding, dentures, bleaching, and cosmetic dentistry. They even offer oral consciousness sedation available for your comfort. That's Marcy Van Ash McKinney Family Dentistry at 807 South 21st. Call for an appointment today, 494-7600. That's 494-7600.
Hi folks, Larry Rath here for Rath Auto Resources, where it's trading time. I really need to keep my lot stocked, so all this month, I'm giving up to $3,100 extra for your trade. Even if you still owe money on your car, up to $3,100 extra goes a long way to help you get into a nicer, newer car today. Call, go online, or come by and choose from a great selection of Rath Road Ready cars, trucks, and SUVs. Each one hand-picked and inspected in our Meineke Car Care Center. Plus, our For the People credit approval process works with the country's best banks and lenders to make sure you drive off with the payment you can afford. If you're keeping the car you have, let us take care of it for you in our Meineke Car Care Center with free AC performance checks, half-off brakes, and buy three, get one free on all tires. Better yet, trade it in for something nicer and newer today and get up to $3,100 extra on trade during trading time at Arkansas's favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources, and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online, rathauto.com.
Requires bank approval. Negative equity may be refinanced. Offer absolutely ends by May 31st, 2021.
ESPN 95.3.
Good morning to the Morning Rush, everybody.
First baseline's open. The pitch is ripped deep to left field by Webb, and it's way out of here. Braden Webb, it's his third home run of the season.
Mother's Day is coming up. Fill out the best TV mom's bracket at hitthatline.com for your chance to win prizes from Gregory Jewelers, Premier Day Spa, and Overstreet's Jewelers.
Back here on the Morning Rush. Now, I've gotten close to hitting hole in one time in my entire life. It was about seven feet from the,
Gator golf.
Was it it's about 7 feet from the pin, and I have not gotten that close since. I mean, it's close.
Seven
for me.
Feet is close.
That's not close to a hole in one.
That's close for me on a par three.
Okay, close. Relative, I guess you're
well,
right.
I'm talented at a lot of things. Golf is not one of them. I suck at golf, so you're gonna have to have some patience with me on Friday. Luckily, I'm only playing 9 holes because I got to skedaddle and get back to Fayetteville for my little sis's graduation. But just bear with me on Friday because you're not the most patient person.
Hey, listen,
out there.
I bear with you every day. I'm sure Friday will be no different than what I do Monday through Friday.
You'll have whiskey and land sharks this time. You won't have to stay sober like you do from 6 to 9 every day.
All right, Clay hit a hole in one, but it doesn't count. We'll tell you the story coming up. It's brought to you by Will's RV, 5 miles west of exit 72 off I-49 in Springdale. All the best brands at the best prices. Peace of mind comes with a lifetime warranty that's on every new unit they sell. Plus, they have a mobile service shuttle that'll keep you camping as well. Stop in at Wheels RV, 5 miles west of exit 72 off I-49 in Springdale. Find out why they were voted the best RV dealership in Northwest Arkansas. That's Wheels RV. Seek, explore, and discover with Wheels RV.
So before we do that,
what's going in the Bud Light Seltzer podcast. We were talking about the most celebrable sport on campus. You can't find baseball tickets, really. Basketball is going to be close that way. Football, we'll see what happens after Texas. We talked about how it looks like we're heading in the technology direction where certain sports leagues are going to be played on weird things with Amazon Prime Video getting the rights to NFL Thursday Night Football starting in 2022. Heard a great story from Clay and Tommy and me about our favorite concerts. Got those from our listeners this morning. We also gave credit to Jeff Long for the hiring of Courtney Dyfel. Mainly Clay.
Clay did.
More than anything.
Clay's a big Jeff Long fan.
He's a huge Jeff Long fan. One of the biggest. But now it's time. What people have been waiting for is to hear how Clay did the hole in one. Now, Clay, I was honest with you. You asked me if I read your story. I told you I skimmed it.
When I read the whole thing, word for word, Clay.
When you write sports,
every word.
When you write sports stories, I will read those word for word.
It's a golf story. You mean what? Sports story? But it was just golf and look down your nose at golf.
It was about him though. Like when it's on Arkansas sports, I'll read
Here's
it
your opening,
word
dude.
For word. So, tell us your late. Was this technically a State of the Hogs piece, or was this just a Clay Henry column?
State of Clay.
State of Clay.
It was just one of my commentaries, let's put it that way. Okay. We didn't put State of the Hogs on that one. Yeah, there's some of them. The fishing and some others. If I mention Razorbacks in there, then we can kind of do that. But, you know, I leave that up to Matt Jones. If he thinks it's State of the Hogs, then he puts the title on it. But, yeah, I'm getting fitted for clubs by Todd Dunaway, who's in the process of taking the job at Paradise Valley. So he's headed back home. Todd is the head pro the last 7 years at Big Creek in Mount Home, which is a great place, great golf course. But the practice facility was closed a couple of weeks ago, and so I'm working with some of these demo clubs. They're all 7-irons, and – the one that I really like is this Mizuno. Actually, I tried the Mizuno Blades and Mizuno Forged. He said, just go out on the back nine. There wasn't anybody playing. Nobody was making the turn. So I went out there and tried different shots, and I went to number 13, which is about 165 down the hill.
Got to avoid the tree on the left, the bunker on the left.
Yeah, yeah. And
trouble if you go long, steep
downwind,
off the back.
And so
right's no good.
Yeah, that 7-iron shot wasn't where the tee marker was, so I had my range finder, and I found the right distance. And so Todd's coming up the hill in a cart bringing me some other 7-irons. He was changing out shafts, you know, fitting me. And I think I hit 8 balls to the green, and one of them went in. Now, you can't count a hole-in-one when you're practicing. You can't count a hole-in-one when you're not at the right tee mark. Well, you might can. You probably should.
Yeah.
I probably would.
My grandpa's hit 5, my late grandpa, so I don't think I'm going to catch him anytime soon.
I had 3. One of them was in competition. And I also made a hole-in-one. I jarred it with a 1-iron. 218 yards. So that's my highlight. So I don't really worry about what I don't count because I can count those. The one iron was made in Washington, D.C., playing with my uncle, who's a lobbyist in Congress. He took me to his course, and it cost my dad $600, the bar tab. So I was 22, and he didn't stick me with the tab. But he did call my dad. And so that was fun. But anyway, I made this hole in one, and I knew immediately I couldn't count it. You know, it's at least Todd was out there, and we've ordered these Mizuno irons. The ones I made a hole in one with, we ordered those. So it'll be a few weeks before I get them. So it's but that's a lot of fun, and it's fun to be fitted with somebody who knows your golf swing. We've played together and also knows the game. So it's if you haven't ever been fitted for clubs, that's a neat experience.
I thought it was neat from your story. You'd gotten the set you've been playing with, the set of Ping I2s from Mike Holder when you were covering Oklahoma State. That's decades ago.
Yeah, that's a long time ago. It was in the 80s, and Pat Jones set up the round where I was playing with the OSU school president, Mike Holder. And I've got these McGregor tourneys, blades that I played with in college, and he's like, Mike, held them up. He says, just hang these on the wall. Yeah. These are antiques, and you don't, you know, the new clubs, these Ping I2s. And he checked with Bill Connors, my boss at Tulsa World. Can I send Clay this? Is this unethical? He goes, no, you can send them to him. So they were a used set that Scott Verplank had changed the line, you know, went from a black dot to a blue dot. Mm-hmm. So they, you know, Mike sent me those.
So if anyone listening this morning wants a vintage set of Ping I2s, contact Clay. The heel and the toe are chewed up. The sweet spot's like new.
It's like
but,
new.
But, you know, if you can live with a chewed up heel and toe.
And I've got new grips. New grips. Yeah.
Clay's got a set. He'll sell cheap.
Yeah. One iron through L wedge. Yeah.
There you go.
What Lee Trevino said.
Not sure it'll be cheap, though. These are collector's items, too. Yeah.
Well, Clay, I got a question for you this morning. We're going to be a part of the 25th Annual Arkansas Baptist Children's Home and Family Ministries Golf Classic. Do you want to play on our team? I'm going to be doing the show. The golf is going to start at 8:15. Do you want to golf that day?
I think Tommy's mentioned that, and the date didn't seem like it worked. I can't remember what the conflict was, but that would be fun. And
Coach Pimmett's going to be out there, Clay.
Yeah, I think that, you know, 5 hours with you might be a little much. 2 hours is tough. 2 days a week, but 5 hours with you, 9 holes would be about right, you know, that to be able to walk away after 9 holes. So I think I'm already committed for that
something
day. Tommy, is that the tournament we talked about?
Yep, I think it was.
It is. So, yeah, okay.
It's going to be at Lost Springs Golf Club in Rogers. The goal of this whole golf classic is to raise funds for the needs of foster children and needy families in Arkansas. Again, I mentioned Sam Pittman is going to be a part of this as well. There's also going to be a meet and greet with Coach Pittman at noon. So if you're interested in all this, go to arkansasfamilies.org. Again, it's arkansasfamilies.org. You'll see a Drive for Hope tab with Coach Sam Pittman. We're really excited about that. Tommy's not going to let me golf, but I'll be doing the show up there. So
yeah, I heard there's a meet and greet for you too, Ty, and it'll be a short line.
It'll be a very I don't know if there'll be a line whatsoever. I think people just stopped by and spat on me, which, listen, I'll take it, I guess. I do have another question for you, Clay. So got a chance to experience Baton Rouge, Louisiana this weekend. Came back with a few minor bumps and scratches. You told me to call Bobby Gregory yesterday at Mr. Autoglass, and he helped me out. And they did it. Him and Steve helped me do it in less than 20 minutes. So really appreciate those guys with the window snafu I was having to deal with in Baton Rouge this weekend. Clay, I looked at the calendar yesterday, and obviously during fall football we're booked up and stuff. I've got a wedding that day of the LSU game, mm-hmm. which is November the 13th. And this is a good friend of mine. He was my roommate my senior year.
He's getting married in football season?
Yeah. We got to talk
on a
to
Saturday?
Him.
I'd evaluate that friendship.
Got to talk to him about that. I got a couple of these. That's like, guys, like, plan your weddings around me. It's going to be harder for me to make it.
You got to have a license, just like deer season. You know, you got to have a fishing license. You got to have a marriage license. There should be a season on this. You know, from Labor Day till Thanksgiving. No marriage license should be issued for Saturday weddings in Arkansas. Mm-hmm. Saturday weddings between Labor Day and Thanksgiving are prohibited.
So here's the question I posed to you this morning. Because I want to go back to Baton Rouge, and because I didn't get the full experience because their baseball team's trash, and no one was animated or excited mm-hmm. about anything down there.
Even though half your group got thrown out of the stadium, somehow it was...
That's neither here nor
it
there.
It was a boring trip.
But you've talked about, Clay, how you want the teams to be good, and I don't know if LSU football is going to be good, but I know that the tailgating and everything involved that stadium. Do I tell my friend that I'm working in order to go down there for that game? Is that reasonable of me, or is that pig-headed and idiotic, and am I truly a friend for potentially skipping his wedding to go work down Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Clay?
So here's your dilemma. Do you stay true to your friend, or do you stay true to Tommy, who's paying you?
It's a good
think
question.
About that.
It's a great question.
I mean, it's so Tommy? Now that he knows that you have an important choice, if you pick work, I think it really looks good for your future employment.
Okay. What say you there?
I think you ought to ride to the game with Clay.
I'm
I'm down with that.
What do you think, Clay?
Clay can drive.
Have to get a haircut first.
I'm getting the haircut on Wednesday, actually.
I thought I would hire a stylist to come to Gaston's and we'll fix you up this weekend.
My boy Steven's fixing me up on Wednesday. I had to decide if I'm going to get a full chop or just a trim. Still
I think you should get a flat top.
You think a flat top? Like military flat top?
Yeah, we'll get you some product.
Okay. I will at least entertain the idea. I'm not going to go fully invested in that.
Get you some Brill cream.
But yeah. I do like that you mentioned ideas. I do like the idea of me and Clay Henry driving down to Louisiana together. Now, I'll tell you what,
Send
Clay.
Send a GoPro. I can just imagine the videos that come out of this deal.
Clay, you'll be driving because the moment we cross the border, we're going to stop at a daiquiri stand and we're going to get one for me. Now, you can't drink one because obviously you're driving, but I don't know
that counts in Louisiana.
I will tell you this. Gas station food in Louisiana is pretty good.
That I agree with. It smelled good to the crawfish. I'll tell you what. There would be a lot of people that would be interested in that video that you were talking about of the GoPro or just the stories that would come out of that weekend. I think we could get a bunch of people to sponsor Clay and Ty go to Baton Rouge. Clay, I'll take you to Tigerland. We'll have some fun down there. You'll be the oldest one by 40-plus years, but we'll have a good time.
Might be fun. It'll be a once-in-a-lifetime trip.
Yeah, for Clay Henry.
Because it will only happen once.
And never again. For Clay, Tommy, and SmackDown, I'm Ty. We'll talk tomorrow.
The Mega Millions jackpot from the Arkansas Scholarship Lottery